This program is rated MA. It contains adult themes, coarse language, sexual references, and violence.
Okay, what's up? All right, welcome to Open Comms Show. Shots.
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 Right,
yeah, shots. You guys didn't see that one coming, yeah. Did you?
Take that. That's a little out of the
norm. I still got to broadcast out to the fucking Imperium. So. Like, we didn't even get them. So, you know, I mean, this is how, like, behind the fucking curve we are tonight.
All right, so, yeah, Open Comms Show Friday night. The main crew is all here, except we're missing LB, but we got Blastem to help back this week, so how's it going, man?
Good.
Vegas inhabitant.
Yeah, whatever you want to call it tonight.
Yeah.
Okay, I just broadcast out to the
Imperium. Yeah, okay.
Jesus. Look, it's just us
I'm
tonight.
On the ball.
It's just us. It's just like regulars on the show tonight. I mean, you know, who knows? Maybe we'll like, you know, take a phone in from the audience or, you know, some crazy shit. But...
First time, long time.
I gotta be honest, fucking after last week, man, it's like, you know, we just gotta fucking Tito's and chill and shit, man. It's like, yeah, you know, we can't have that kind of drama going on, man. Like, you know, it starts getting my heart all fucked up.
I don't know. I think I lost like the last half of last week's show. I know that we had Progod on, I know that we asked him some questions, and I'm sure he gave some answers.
We had Sapporo on, and he kept yelling, "I have the talking stick" or something like that.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
So it was everyone, like, screaming at each other, and he would just scream, "I have the talking stick," and that was the only thing I could make out.
And then it was the conch.
Well, I kept saying the conch, because Lord of Flies is like, "I got the conch."
Do you hear they're making an all-female Lord of the Flies?
Are they?
Yes, yes.
So are they calling it the Lordess of the Flies?
Lord of the fucking Ghostbusters, whatever. It's like, please.
Yeah, I don't get it. Wasn't a requirement, I think, in American schools. They had to read Lord of the Flies.
Yeah, I had to read it in, like, ninth grade
I mean, they're all kids, so I don't know what difference it'd make, male or
female.
Next
we're going to have Catcher in the Rye be a girl.
Well, it's like, I don't know why they're going to change the... It's like, they made the movie, and the guy wrote the book. It's like, why do you have to change the characters around in the book just to appease some, you know, new age millennial gender society? Like, it's just like,
hey. You could probably make them all, like, gender neutral or something like that, and then as long as, like, their personalities are the same, it wouldn't really matter. But they're kids, they're like five.
Well, I mean,
same as a five-year-old girl. It doesn't really make a difference.
It was like a boys' private school that crashed on the island, so it's like...
Yeah, but all they did was kill each other. Well, they killed the fat kids.
That's what fucking flies do, and, you know, and one of them's gotta be Lord. I mean... But anyways, you know, since we're completely off fucking track, what?
Oh, Lord Doe is saying, like, show is fixing to start. Yeah, show's already going, Lord Doe.
The show's
refresh.
Going, man. Fucking refresh or,
oh,
you know,
he won't see it. You guys have to type it to him.
Do
well,
we?
No.
Oh, that's true. He won't hear us. If he doesn't think the show's going, he won't hear us. See, like, you know, we're just...
That's true. We keep yelling restart.
I tried.
Like, freaking re-rees.
I tried. I gave as much effort as I'm willing to give.
Anyways, okay, let's get on track here. Just a little bit. Look, I'm not going to be on track like I was last week, which apparently for 90 freaking minutes. And I got to tell you something. Okay, you're right. I mean, that was kind of like talking in Station's Dirk there for that first 90 freaking minutes and everything.
That's exactly what it was.
Number one, I hadn't seen Subaru Jones in a while. And I didn't remember he could be as chatty as he was, cuz I know Progod can talk like a mofo. And you know, I didn't realize that that Sapporo I didn't remember that he could talk as freaking much as any of us. So that was like, that was kind of freaking good and everything. Last week was a great goddamn show. I got to be totally fucking honest. I'm not saying it was the height of fucking journalism, but it was totally goddamn Open Comms Eve. But you know, this week we're kind of coming down off that high. We're coming down off that freaking high drama that, you know, like burns so quickly in Eve and then just kind of like fades away. Who knows? We may have some comments later on.
Dane, did you do a shot without us?
Well, I was just doing a shot with Shooter. Yeah, I mean, like,
I'll do a shot.
You called him a shot? Like, well, fuck it.
Contractually obligated to do shots with Shooter whenever he puts my channel because he pays me money for it.
Yeah, can I do a shot to Waffles for playing Overwatch with me this whole week? By the way, Overwatch is free this weekend.
Waffles as in like the Alliance or is somebody out there?
Yeah, the Alliance. Yeah, so like Kieran Heckey, Figgles, Tiana Stark, MKD, Reaper.
Boom,
MKD.
That was another shot for people out there just in case. Yeah, because like shots. For those of you who kind of came in late because I was really bad at broadcasting to the Imperium, we did a shot like literally out of the fucking gate.
Yep. Oh, sorry, Zeke's.
Right now, Caleb is listening to this on replay and going, holy shit, Dirk's two shots in. This will get nothing but fucking ugly. But no, I'm going to try and control that. I'm just, you know, because again, it's just fucking Tito's and chill, right? But I do want to say this. 12 days. 12 fucking days. We're 12 days out, I think, for most of us who are on this channel that are going. Rain's coming in. Rain's 13 days. But yeah, we're 12 days out of arriving on Wednesday for eVegas. We've got one more show between now and then. Freaking, you know, somewhere along the line, I lost count or some shit. I don't know what the hell it was. And that could just be blackout something or other. But damn, 5 Fridays in September, it was like, you know. I'm like, damn, how many more shows do we, like, this is how I measure shit, right? How many shows until Vegas, right? And I kind of got lost in there.
Yeah, I'm fine with, I like months with 5 Wednesdays. Because that's payday for me.
Wednesday's payday, not Friday?
Yeah, I get paid on Wednesday. It's nice to have 5 paydays in the same month.
You paid on Wednesdays?
Wait, you get paid every Wednesday, not like every
That's
other?
An employer I get paid at, so I get, weird. I get paid
every week. I get paid weekly on Wednesday.
It's so weird.
It's nice. It's actually really nice like because it. If it's I forget foreign, to cash my check like on it. Payday, I have 2 more days before the banks close. So I have leeway of like,
you don't
oh
have,
shit.
You don't have direct Wait, deposit direct either, deposit? What?
No, I don't have direct
Rain,
deposit.
Rain,
I know you're a millennial. You don't understand these things. But back in my day,
we
used to take paper checks to the bank.
So, well, in my day, you just when I was phone, when I was,
you also know I live in
Rain. You're the same age.
I stuffed cash in my mattress. Come on now, yeah,
shut up, baby boomers.
You also know I live
in Idaho. Baby boomers, like, get your generations right.
We just discovered the internet like last decade.
There's a whole generation between millennials.
Oh,
and
hold on. I just saw him type out there, so I want to say this to fucking Wolf Glenn, would you please check freaking that thing Slack apparently where you and Dre.
Oh, you cut out, Dirk.
Then you need to get back to me, but whatever.
All right, hold on.
Was there like an awkward silence?
I'm gonna reel it back.
Is that
you said like where you and Drayden, and then we had silence until the last.
Oh, sorry. Where a Slack that you and Drayden are both in?
Oh yeah, Wolf Glenn. Yes. Let me find him. He might be in chat. Wolf Glenn.
Yeah, he is in chat. I saw him like chat. Yeah, okay. Like, you know. So while I'm still fucking remembering. Anyways, I'm gonna reel this shit fucking back in. Because I started off with there's 12 days until Vegas, you know, on the 12th day of fucking Vegas. Could you imagine that? Fucking 12 days
like
of Vegas?
Ball.
That
would sound like you were going to go into a Christmas.
I don't know if we'd live that long. Like,
halfway
imagine,
through,
like,
people would actually not enjoy
it.
Yeah, that's
what
it sounded like you're going with. On the 4th day of Vegas. Yeah,
you know. That would be so bad. Man. It would be like. Me. Like there'd be fucking bodies everywhere, fucking hands and shit, whatever. Anyways, but I do want to make a public service announcement for those people that are actually going to Vegas. Okay, again, Open Comms will be broadcasting live from out there somewhere in the link. Okay, I'm not quite sure exactly where it will be. It will probably be not too far from wherever CCP is hosting their little piece of the event. Still don't know where that is. However, we'll be communicating that in various places, one of which will be an Imperium fucking broadcast when it actually happens, as well as like talking in stations, talking in Vegas channel, and, you know, on Twitter and stuff like that about exactly where we will be. We will, you know, do that in advance. That show will start at 6 p.m. local time, okay? Which is normal show time, but, you know, since we'll be out in like the West Coast part of the world country, it'll be 6 p.m. for those of you who are actually in Vegas. It will be live, but it will be on Thursday night. It will not be Friday night. So next week's show will be on Friday night. The week after will be on Thursday night. And that's because I'm not fucking up my Friday night in Vegas to do this show. I'm going on the pub crawl. So just to let everybody freaking know, it's not going to be on Friday. Now, Thursday night is also the night that the Imperium dinner at the, what is it? The Hofbräuhaus. Hofbräuhaus.
Not worth.
Now, that starts at 8 p.m., okay? So obviously, if you're going over there to have some fucking schnitzel and beer, you're going to have to leave a little bit early, but you still have time to make it. I know people like Boat are coming by and... HVAC will definitely fucking crash the goddamn
Boat said he's not going to Vegas.
Oh, then I guess fucking Boat won't be there. But Boat's HVAC is going to fucking crash the show.
Well, Boat's not going.
Well, whatever. Oh my God, you know, it's so fucking sad. Oh my God, that's just like sad. People should like give him shame for not being in Vegas.
Like, really there's no squeaky bee on someone's hat I can squeak now.
Well, Boat has like... Yeah, Boat's doing some other, like, apparently super important stuff with life, and so says life's not in the way.
So, well, during the show...
Yeah, that's right. Let him have
ton of these. Shot glasses.
Fucking so OpenCom shot glasses, bitches.
Shot glasses, OpenComs, broadcaster shots, shot glasses. So, I want to give away every single one of them. I got a couple already... kind of designated for a few people that called dibs, but yeah, shot glasses, open comms. Here we go.
Do I get one?
Dibs.
No.
Fuck.
What?
I missed out.
Yeah. God, what the fuck?
Fucking Bastion. Get your Bastion shot glass someplace, bro.
Don't worry,
or your Bastion coffee mug or whatever.
Yeah.
Rain, we'll just find out.
I got a deep coffee mug.
No, even better. We'll just steal shot glasses from people he gives them to.
Yes.
I got little plastic disposable shot glasses for everybody else to, like, you know, because we will be pouring Tito's that night, you know, just there. So, you know, whatever. You should bring your beer that you want to drink or whatever. But, you know, we will definitely be pouring fucking Tito's at the Open Comms live show. So, yeah. Boom. Are we doing another shot?
I'm going to throw this one out to Random McNally. He got smashed in the
fucking
ass.
Random got smashed
in the ass by a Camaro when he was stuck.
He was in an SUV and a Camaro rear-ended him. He's showing the back of his car, and I'm like, fuck that, bro. I want to see the front end of the Camaro.
Right, but it was
He said the Camaro was totaled, right?
The Camaro went all the way back to the windshield. Yeah, no, apparently he was stopped and it hit him at like 60 miles an hour.
Mm-hmm. Which I'm really surprised
somebody walked away from in a Camaro.
Yeah, but he said he was in the hospital, so hopefully he's doing okay. I think he is, but hopefully, you know, nothing serious happened there.
Shots.
But yeah, he did have to go to the hospital, which is exactly what... Listen to me. If somebody fucking rear-ends you people, okay, be like, oh, man, I need to go to the fucking hospital. Like, that's what you need as part of that. Their insurance company will pay you more claim. Just be like, I don't know. You know, it's like... I was there and it happened I'm not quite sure because my head fucking like, you know, hit the windshield. And
the other thing too is like, you may think, oh no, insurance fraud, like you might be okay. The thing is though, is when you get hit, you get the adrenaline rush. So you don't notice if you're actually injured. So like the next day or a couple days later, you're going to be like, oh my fuck, I should have gone and like filed a claim and shit. So you always want to file a claim or at least get checked out by a doctor. Because
if you can rat or mine for like 3 months on somebody else's paycheck, you totally fucking should do that.
Yeah.
Oh shit. Kevlar Lal just resubbed for 23 fucking months. One more to go, man. You get that sweet ass 2 year full gold bling chain thing right
Lord
before Do- your name.
Lord
Do- you get
is
one
like
more
Texas
month.
Just outlawed Texas texting and driving. It's like, yeah, Texas just always did. Right there at the fucking forefront of fucking logic.
Are you kidding? Texting and driving has been outlawed in my state for at least 5 years.
It's been outlawed in my state for I think at least 2.
And you know what's funny is it's easier to text and drive right now with like smartphones.
No, it is not. Do not look at your goddamn fucking phone.
It's easier right now with smartphones than it was back in the old fucking days of flip phones and having to like hit the button 3 times.
Yeah, where you can count how to text and you can feel the buttons. No, now you have to have a smart screen and like you don't have speed dial on anything. You have to actually type in a phone number if you want to call them. I miss my old flip phone where I could just hold two, and it was like, oh, I can call my mom and say, hey, mom, I'm on the way to blah, 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 instead of like, oh, let me get on my smartphone, scroll through bullshit, attempt to text, and I have to look at the numbers, hey, I'm driving.
Hildifer just reset for 31 months. Thanks, man. Holy shit.
God damn.
And then...
This will come as a surprise to fucking nobody, okay? But right after my daughter got her fucking license, we're out there, and it's like, you know, I don't know, I was running her around, and my fucking wife's crawling at my fucking ear and all that. Not that Mrs. McGurk is bad. She's not. She absolutely deserved to crawl at my fucking ear that day. Okay, but I'm sitting there fucking texting, like, you know, like, as I'm, coasting into a stoplight, all right? And my daughter's like, you're not supposed to do that. And I'm like, listen to me. Do as I say, not as I fucking do. I grew up in a different generation.
So
there's an entirely different bunch of things that we do.
People are talking about voice to text. You have to actually press a button to do voice to text. And I've tried that. It is terrible. Like, I have to turn off my radio. I have to turn off the air conditioning. I have to turn off the heat. I have to turn off sound. Just be able to say, hey, can you do this? Or something
like
that.
Voice to text is so bad. That shit will get you, like, called a racist or thrown in jail or, like, you know, all kinds of things.
And, like, when you're trying to say something, so, like, let's say you say it and you're like, okay, did I, like, remotely say that properly? And you don't, and it doesn't make sense, you have to do it all over again. So then you also have to then read your phone, which you should not be doing either. Just because you're not texting doesn't mean you should still have your phone out. I am super, so there's two things I hate in life. That's people being dumb fucks on the road, and that's drinking and driving. Both which falls under dumb fucks on the road. So if you're texting and driving, if you're drinking and driving, if you're fucking trying to do your
texting,
makeup
and
driving, I will
driving?
Fucking murder you.
That's the hat trick.
No, like,
and eating a Taco Bell taco?
I almost got pushed off the road, like, literally Wednesday when driving back from a chiropractor because somebody thought that they could cut across two lanes of traffic, jack fucking off, and not check over the right shoulder to see if I was on the road or not. So wow. I'm sitting there slamming on my horn as they're doing jack fuck all. And, like, that's not the first time I've almost died while driving. That's maybe the third. No, Dirk, let me finish my rant. Fuck shitty drivers, Dirk. Don't fucking text and drive. And I swear to God, if you did a car while drinking and driving, I will literally call the cops on you.
See, there you go. And you know what?
I've paid my dues for that, and I only text when I'm at stoplights.
Truckers have the right of way, right?
Semi drivers, yes.
Yes,
always,
exactly.
You always respect a semi driver.
Because I wanted to get you on Mean Harry's fucking good graces out there. Because I want
to
give a shout out.
I've been talking to him. Yeah, okay.
Because I want to give a shout out to my man Mean Harry, who had his fucking Dodge. I don't know what it is. Fucking, like, Colorado, I think it was. It's not a Dakota, because a Dakota is a lesser vehicle, I believe. You know, he had his fucking Dodge Colorado, I think, you know, for like a week before some fucking nerd rear-ended him because they were too busy fucking, like, you know, checking, like, what mom said on Snapchat.
I agree with Nairbear, though. Since you said the guy went across two lanes, like, while jerking or something, like, Nairbear is saying, what
have
is
you ever
the
jerked
rule
while driving?
On jerking and driving?
No, so I don't
never
know if he was actually driving.
I gotta be honest, you really
but
gotta be ready to fucking,
like,
go. I mean,
if it's like distracted driving,
so
like,
if you have an automatic, it's fine because you only need one hand to hold the steering wheel anyway.
Who
yeah,
doesn't have
it,
a fucking automatic
depends,
now?
Right?
Trying with
right?
my
so,
I feel like you'd be better at jerking it if you had the stick, though. Like, with all the practice.
So if
no,
you're
if
distracting and driving, so like if you're eating food or like jacking off or fucking like staring at the scenery, if you distract and drive, like some people can do it, right? Like you can be in the right hand lane. Driving 50 miles an hour, staring at the fucking wildflowers, and that's fine, right? You're not in anyone's way, you're not doing anything. But if you're like, oh man, like, let me fucking jack off, and you just fucking swerve all over the interstate like this motherfucker was, like, you just need to die in a fire. Like,
I love how you just, like, all encompassed. Like, if you're just, like, looking at scenery or eating food or jacking off while you're driving,
like,
some people can do it.
If you're doing something that's kind of distracted driving, but you're not putting yourself as a danger to others, that's fine. If you're doing something that's distracted and driving, but it's not like texting and driving, which is a big no-no, drinking and driving, big no-no, and you're just fucking swerving everywhere, then you're a fucking danger to society.
Actually,
and
this is one of the problems I have with the whole freaking, like, you know, texting and driving and whatnot, you know, thing is, it's like, look, don't be so specific about it. You have got to teach these kids to not be distracted in driving, regardless of what it is, because you can be distracted in many ways. My daughter, for example, okay, distracted over fucking arguing with other people in the car or, like, the drama that kids get into and shit like that.
She's,
you
one of those people,
like,
that has to look at you to talk to you.
It's not just about texting. It's not just about talking on a cell phone.
That drives
it's
me
not
nuts.
Just about this.
When
if
I'm the
you're
past...
way too into your fucking Van Halen song and you're, like, fucking rocking out and shit, like, you could also be distracted. Right. If you're eating a fucking double Whopper with cheese, you know, while, you know, with one hand while you're riding down the road, still trying to smoke a cigarette, yeah, you could be fucking distracted.
We've
There's
definitely...
a lot of ways of being fucking distracted.
We have derailed off of Eve, but I mean, there's a whole not a ton of Eve topics, but
and that's
I think,
why I want to pull us back. That's
but wait, before but hold on, before really? You pull us back, let me get in this thing. The thing that drives me nuts is when I'm a past, because I've been driving for like what 16, 17 years. I've never been.
Yeah,
in
you're
a wreck.
A fucking veteran, bro.
No, I'm just saying. After that long, I've never been in a car wreck as a driver. I've been in like 6 car wrecks as a passenger. So. And it terrifies me. It drives me nuts when I'm sitting there as the passenger and the person driving. It's okay if you look over once in a while, but like when they're talking and they're just like, hey, and they like sit there and look at you for like 20 seconds. It's like, dude, you gonna watch the fucking road? I can hear you. You don't have to look at me to talk to me.
We're
I can listen to you
screen,
without eye contact. Like, trust me, I'm listening. Watch the fucking road, please. That's my 2 bits. Okay, we can go back to Eve now.
Now, see, I've been driving long enough where I literally can't ride in the passenger seat of somebody else's car without being completely unfucking comfortable. And it's like, really? Look, I am glad that I've been married long enough where my wife knows that when she walks up to a vehicle, she just gets into the passenger side because my fucking privilege will not allow her. Well, that's not true. We pulled out of New Orleans after a week of being in New Orleans, and I'm like, I'm going to drive. And like 80 miles outside New Orleans, I'm like, baby, you got to drive. I can't do it anymore. But that was like the last time, like 1994. Okay, so I just can't fucking do it. And as much as I love her, it's like, you know what? I'm sorry. We're both going to die, or I'm just going to freak the fuck out and die and whatever.
I'm a really good passenger driver because I always pay attention to the road as well as a passenger. Oh. So, like, but, I mean, that's how, like, I grew up driving. So, when I turned 16, me and my best friend turned 16, like, same time. So, we would drive to Des Moines and back. And that's how we learned to drive on interstates and cities was driving. So, we'd both pay attention to the road, both communicate what we were doing, etc. So, now as a passenger, I still carry that unless it's with my mom. I literally don't pay attention to when my mom's driving. No,
I have a question.
It's not backseat driving. It's saying, like, oh, hey, the motorcyclist that was way up there is actually coming.
We have to mix our public service announcements with Eve. I got to tell you, otherwise they're going to kick us off Twitch.
Yeah, okay. Well, real quick, though, does it trigger you guys in Iowa when people call it Des Moines?
Yeah.
Des Moines.
Okay. No, it's Des Moines. Like, I know enough finesse.
I literally heard
not
a guy
Menez,
in fucking New York
Moines.
City, goddamn educated businessman.
I called it that until Des sixth grade. I think it was about sixth grade when I learned it was Des Moines.
It's like an educated guy and called it Des Moines.
Swear to God. And we sat there, the two of us sitting across the table from him, looked at each other like this, and we're like, Des Moines?
He called it Des Moines.
He called it fucking Des Moines.
That seems like somebody's fucked up kid name or something.
I don't know.
Des Moines.
Hey, Des Moines.
Oh, man.
Like, and it's not even like, because like if you didn't like know, you'd literally just like going by the, like, you'd be like, Des Moines? Okay, but like, so he thought he was adding something to it by saying Des Moines, right? You know, it's just like, whatever. Okay, but yeah, reeling it fucking back in. Now, one of the things that Rain wants to do after...
Are you seriously after that thing again?
One of the things Rain wants to do after
the
show on Thursday night...
Can you get Bucky and get Bucky to do it?
What?
DC,
we're in the same tribe, so it'll work.
DC, we can hear you.
Fuck, wrong comps.
Fucking Bucky, man. What is this?
Playing
Captain
some fucking
America.
Like, what?
No, he's
right.
Playing.
Right.
Playing
right.
He's,
right.
He's playing. He's playing Ark.
See, this is what we always say. It's like that
I
fucking
have two buttons.
Drunk Canadian guy who's like, you know, here for this Eve-related show, but is always playing something else. But whatever.
I'm here.
Okay, fine. All right. So after the Eve Vegas Open Comm show, I got to pour, but I'm going to talk. Talk here for a bit. So go ahead and do your shit. I'll follow up.
I'll wait. I'll go to you, pour.
Rain would like to go do karaoke. I got to be honest. I would like to go do karaoke as well. However, we're having a hard time finding a karaoke joint that is within like fucking crawling distance after what you should be after our fucking show out there. So what it'll probably be is we either like actually locate one that is like nearby. Or, like, and when I mean nearby, I mean, like, literally fucking nearby. You know, or we're just going to end up at, like, you know, whatever the cool bar is that we're all fucking hanging out with, you know, hanging out at, you know, for that. But I do want to go into this. Blastem, you're part of the volunteer team, so I want you to talk a little bit about what the volunteers are doing, as well as this whole swag bag thing.
Oh, yeah. All right,
swag bag. So we came up with the idea at FanFest to... Because everybody was throwing out stickers, badges, buttons, everything. And we're like, really cool. All right, shots. Drayden told them. All right,
oh,
shots
yeah,
before
yeah,
I get
yeah.
into this.
Shots
right,
for shots. Volunteers.
No, I threw it to you so that like, you had to talk
volunteers.
And like, I can just do a shot.
Yeah.
They do a thankless job. Well, no, it's not thankless.
This is for a gray gal.
Yeah.
Okay, so we kind of came up with the idea at FanFest to put together a welcome bag. Now, we call them a swag bag, but I think CCP called it a welcome bag. It's going to be anybody who has business
condoms
cards,
and penicillin.
Condoms or deodorant.
Wait, did they really give condoms?
No,
dude,
really
imagine
don't.
You
they
have
really
a condom and when you unroll,
amazing if there
it's
was
your,
like,
Alliance logo or something.
Should,
like, now
yeah,
you're
yeah,
really
wait,
getting
should we,
should do fucking should condoms.
Wait, should we, make...
You get fucked by open
condoms. Should we make open comms condoms? Open
no,
condoms?
I'm not fronting that.
Wait, oh, open condoms. They could, we could, like, have a new, like, a great idea. Wait. It could be, like, open at the end.
So up at FanFest, apparently, there was some phage deodorant going. Phage fresh deodorant that was going around.
Design your
and
own
look,
custom
I'm gonna be honest,
condoms. You, oh, my God,
if
you
can got
do
a
it.
Rich motherfucker, if you've got a rich motherfucker out there in your alliance who, like, you know, wants to, like, do something really freaking cool as one of those handout kind of, you know, swag things, I'm going to tell you right now, deodorant. Now, look, we as Americans who generally go to eVegas, okay, are not as deodorant unfriendly as Europeans are who go to FanFest. However,
are you saying there's stinky people?
There are enough, okay? There are enough that maybe some fucking deodorant getting spread around.
Dirk, we're
like,
getting fucking custom condoms.
There we go.
However,
with a swag bag.
Yeah, yeah.
Open condoms.
Whoever the rich guy is in Pandemic Legion, and I haven't met him yet, but I'm going to be honest.
It works,
Pandemic Legion condoms would be fucking badass. With that freaking, like, virus thing on there, that would be fucking amazing.
Kind of representative of, like, an STD.
Oh, my God. Like, we have to do the
Nairbear's
condoms.
Even got, yeah, Nairbear's even got
mistake
the...
biggest mistake
you're going to make. Yeah, yeah. Nairbear's already got the slogan, open condoms, the best mistake you're going to make.
Open condoms.
The best mistake you're going to make. All right,
that really is fucking good for us. And now I'm, like, pissed off that I didn't look up that, and that might actually be on next year's t-shirt.
No, Dirk, I have the link already.
We got it. So, well, getting off condoms with the swag bag.
You know you don't even have to buy the big condoms, right? It's not even like we're a Magnum crowd.
No, you just...
Oh, my God.
Normal size.
Bunch of fucking white boy condoms. It's like, those are like cheap on the down low.
What you could do instead of condoms is you get those, like, finger wraps. You know, like, when you cut your finger and you're a cook.
Oh,
and then
they
you
call
can,
them,
like, yeah,
no, they actually
yeah,
call
the
them finger condoms.
Condoms.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you get a finger condom, but then you pass them out and just say normal condoms, and then everyone just feels like fucking, like, feels
exactly.
super arrogant.
It's not like they're getting laid anyways, right? It's like, it's just more of a gag,
like,
right?
They're just tiny and they're like,
little mini condoms.
It worked for me. Just saying.
So with the bags, we're just going to be collecting, as volunteers, we have a Discord group that was put in the link that Falcon put out for the welcome bag, that we have a Discord channel to coordinate dropping off stuff. So if it's business cards, badges, buttons, whatever it needs to be, we're out collecting that. We're going to put those all together Thursday night and then give them out as people register. So we had a couple requests say, hey, if I don't have 1,200, you know, for the bags, we're like, we'll stuff as many as we want. You
exactly.
know?
The first 500 fucking get it. And that's,
yeah,
and
exactly.
that's the way America works.
First come, first serve. So, yeah, that's a really cool idea. We kind of hatched that one up. And that's all really Gray Gal on her, and she pushed that CCP to get that done. But, yeah, that's what we're doing there. That's the first thing. And then, of course, you know, all day Friday, you find us at the check-in. So I don't know if you want to go into the check-in yet, where that's going to be yet. But, yeah,
we
work the check-in.
This is your time.
The check-in's going to be up on the fifth floor in the block room. That's B-L-O-Q. So... interesting. That's where we'll do the check-in. If I remember right, you go up past the whole convention area up to the fifth floor, and there's an escalator that takes
you get
all
on
way up the there.
Elevator and then go to the fifth floor.
Yep. Yeah, it will tell you where to go. We'll hopefully we're getting signs made to say this is where registration is. This is where the convention area. We have the whole convention area. We have the auditorium. We've got all the ballrooms in that area. We have all the storage.
So why is registration not taking place down in a place that is closer to where the event is going to happen?
I'm not sure. And that was kind of like, I was pushing where they're going to do like that open bar, not open bar, but the bar area with the couches should have been the perfect spot. But I don't know how big those rooms are. So I'm kind of guessing that's because the block room is like 20,000 square feet of just a ballroom. We can fit 1,200 people in there instantaneously, not, you know, have to be on top of each other with needing deodorant.
Not to swing it back to, but Desert Phoenix just came up with another slogan that's really great. Open condoms, first come, first served.
Can you...
He's got like
I'm designing
subtitle
it now.
In there. But I mean, the whole open condom is really the, you know, it's like, that's really what mattered, right?
Like, I'm actually because like, we're really not about glad that Rain actually like, found a site that makes custom condoms. Like we could do.
Yeah, I'll get a surprise. I'll get a surprise. We could choose do this. Color. What color should we have? Oh, we're doing pink. We're doing pink.
I don't want you to get me a fucking price right now because then, right now I'm like five shots deep into this shit and I don't want my fucking MasterCard or Visa coming out like, you know, midway through the fucking show.
Dirk, it's over $500 for a custom condom.
Why? Is it that much?
Fucking t-shirts were over $500.
All right, we're getting custom condoms.
However, if I could have done 1,200 condoms, I may have not done t-shirts.
How many condoms do you get?
You get the 1,200.
1,200? How about like 200?
If I could have protected,
we had to put them in each of the.
If I could have protected the fucking community for the same price as my t-shirts, my t-shirts will only defend a small handful. But I could have protected the community.
Well, no. We don't like. We don't have to put them in the grab bag.
I spent my money wrong.
We have to spend the $500 to make sure nobody gets STDs.
Well, we don't have it yet.
What happens at Vegas stays at Vegas.
We don't. We don't have that yet. It's. I think the wallet's at like four something. So like now, if we get,
I'll front the difference.
Can we give back? No, I'm not giving back everything just to protect these people. It's like, you know, if you don't know who it is to slip your dick into, it's like, I'm sorry, I'm not.
No, we can't hand out.
It's a funny fucking gag. It's a meme. It's a $500 gag.
It's a really funny meme, okay?
It really is totally fucking funny, everyone. And we would not be the fucking king of all fucking fanfics.
So, do we hang out the condoms then?
No, because not everyone's going to use them. Like, you know, a tenth of the people will actually use them for what they're needed, and then, like, the other 90% are just going to put them on and jack off with them because they're pre-lubricated. It's like free lube for jacking off.
I don't want them to use it around me.
And easy cleanup. Not that I've ever done that with a condom, but just saying.
See, and you know, this would be better than the really thin material fucking t-shirt that fucking CCP hands out.
I like those thin t-shirts. They're so soft.
I understand that. I get that. I totally fucking get that. I really fucking do. Okay, however, maybe they should do this in the Eve store. Maybe this should be something where you walk up and be like, yo, get me a six-pack of fucking open condoms. Right? I mean, like, maybe this is something that the Eve store should be providing rather than... I don't know, fucking t-shirts that have, like, crazy fucking slogans on them and shit.
Dirk, how about every time you hand out a t-shirt to a female, you give her an open condom?
Number one, every time I do give out a t-shirt to a female at Eve Vegas, I give her a condom, period. I'm like, look, just bring it with you next time, okay?
Jesus Christ.
However, that's completely fucking different. That's just predatory shit, all right? I don't want CCP to look predatory. I want them to look like they're protecting people, right? Like they're giving you like a fucking tether, right? Like they're giving you a fucking tether on a fucking Keepstar.
Is that true?
How would condoms not protect people?
Protect them? No, I mean, they don't absorb impact. Like,
open condoms, I have no guarantee yet because we will buy Chinese condoms.
But. Should we put CCP on it and then that way CCP can fuck everyone? Hey!
Oh!
Wait, that's
not a character for you. Usually, you're all about CCP.
Damn!
You
know it's fucking cold on CCP. You're not part of Eve TV this year. All of a sudden, right? CCP's just trying to fuck you. Here's a condom.
No, I opted not to do Eve TV. I'm super excited for whoever gets it. We know what.
Tethered for her protection.
Exactly. Oh my God! Jesus, you can have like Christ. Different. You can have like different size. Like, you know.
I love that it's such a slow week with Eve News that our main topic is condoms.
Here's your Astra Who's condom.
Like our top condoms are like a main topic tonight. Like,
Keepstar,
I mean,
motherfucker. There we go.
All right.
Keepstars would be the Magnums, right?
Well, yeah, but there's no one ever needs a Keepstar.
Now, if somebody wants to front up and be like, "Give me the Palatine." Be like, really? Really? But anyways, okay, so there is this fucking swag bag, right? It's going to have stickers in it from places. There's going to be business cards in there from people like Steve Renouk and Elect Me Again
other people out there.
Wingspan Delivery Service and, like, you know, shit like that, right? We're going to have that.
Jaden, don't you know if you like
probably,
a girl?
Probably
you
fucking
just
like,
trade
you know,
her a thorax.
Hard Knocks and shit. Hard Knocks stickers will be in there. You might find a fucking PL sticker in there. Who knows?
I just give him an Imperator.
And those are that's my shit.
We'll give
fucking
out,
like,
yeah,
you know,
so
Eve
we'll
these,
coordinate
but...
through the Discord channel that we have. It's volunteers, Eve Vegas Volunteers Discord app, and just get a hold of anybody whose name appears in purple. That's how we can. decipher who's who.
Yeah, I told you. Listen, get into that fucking Discord channel, because again, it'll be one of those places where people are talking during eVegas about what's going on. And if you're one of those people who's like, what's going on? Well, you know what? Have all your motherfucking channels open. Keep your fucking ear to the goddamn ground about what's going on.
For sure. And you know, there's the Imperium Telegram group for people who are in that. That's a lot of coordination goes on through there.
Dude, I was in the Imperium for like 3.5 years. I didn't even know about this. Did this like just come up or?
Yeah, it was about a year ago they started having the Telegram group. So last year we did that for a lot of the Vegas events and just getting where we needed to be and herding cats. And as far as Vegas, we really didn't have a big one. We used to have an in-game channel, just eVegas for, God, many years. And that was ZappaWorks put that one together a long time ago. As long as the event itself.
There's that crazy other fucking
app,
WhatsApp or whatever the fuck it was. You know, WhatsApp for this, nice. WhatsApp for that, and it's like, eh.
So for those who don't have all these little groups, we can just use it's like hashtag eVegas, right? Is that what we use every year?
Yeah, on Twitter, hashtag eVegas.
Yep.
Derek, I don't think they're doing 2017, but it's just hashtag eVegas.
Yep. So just reference like the eVegas show and stuff like that. I noticed like all the templates you gave me had two co-hosts. Who's the second one?
I thought, Elby would be there as well, but...
Has anybody talked to him?
Well, not since last week's show, no.
Maybe we should get, like, a big wig.
A big wig?
Maybe we get Jay Amazing.
We're gonna... Okay, you say big wig, and then all of a sudden you roll out a fucking I'm gay for Jay bullshit, okay?
Are you telling me you're not gay for Jay?
The primary focus, this is one of the things I was trying to explain to the people behind the fucking buttons, you know, that weren't in fucking Vegas, is the primary focus of the Vegas stream will be the players part. That are there and the devs that are there. Believe me, I'm going to tell you right now, when you talk about big wigs, okay, it's not about like, I don't know, Jay Amazing, who's not there, okay, and
which
not
is like a funny
legitimately
side
a big wig.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like, just like a cool dude on the side.
I do know
like
what,
LB's
you, I do know
like
what
gets,
you mean, but here's one
like
of the
LB's
problems.
LB's my buddy and everything, but he gets very tired of sleeping.
Here's one of the problems with eVegas, right? Even though we've got fucking headphones and we're trying to isolate what it is we hear, we can't because it gets so fucking loud.
You're preaching to the choir.
That's why me and Dirk always lose our voices in Vegas, too. It gets so loud, we're always yelling.
But that wasn't really Drayden's fault. I seem to remember Dirk McGurk not being able to hold up Drayden's weight, and then Drayden fell.
No, it's true.
No. It's not that he couldn't hold my weight. He just dropped me off.
I cut off after like 45 minutes. Believe me, I walk away after that, and then I tongue a guy right at the end. And it's
He intentionally dropped me. Like he's just like I got you, bro.
It did kind of look like he like threw your legs off. Like
no, he did. He did. It was one of those like trust things where you like fall back and they're supposed to catch you. He's like, I got you. Poof.
As soon as the flash mic drop and he's out. As soon as the picture has been taken, like you're gone. I cast you off.
Yeah, he's like, oh, wait, photo
ops over.
I can't
believe you guys made it into a Twitch Tales compilation.
Well, that was the second time. The first time was not so pretty. That one was like all in good fun.
The first one was not so funny on a Twitch Fails compilation because like.
Did you know?
Was that the Christmas one or the New Year's one?
Yeah, that was the New Year's one.
Yeah, that was really a
that one was all in good fun
though.
That was just like
the other one was actually a fail.
I was glad though when I watched that Twitch Fails that. Ours was not the one that everyone focused on. I actually looked at a lot of the YouTube comments, and no one gave a shit about our clip. Because
you
which
showed
is good.
No boob. Because you showed no
I
boob.
I did show no boob.
It was no boob
Drayden
that
got
night.
Pretty good booty for twerking. It's a good booty.
Yeah, it's a big booty. You know.
I mean, for a white ginger, you got a pretty good booty.
I'll confirm.
It's like two handfuls. It's not like three like you need, but it's two.
But
here is
the thing about the show.
For your booty?
Oh, you need three for a good. Anyway.
Here's the thing about the show that we do out there. Okay, look, it is not a normal fucking show. We are not talking about dev blogs. We're not talking about what fucking announcement came out that week. We're not even talking about this rando shit that we have fucking talked about tonight. It is about one of the co-hosts that are here, okay, that are going to be out there, and somebody else from out there. You may be a fucking dev. You may be a fucking player. You may be like, you know, chances are, if you're getting on the fucking show, you're somebody that we know. You're a fucking, like, you know, high-class listener or, you know, something like that, right? It is about the experience of what's happening out there. that is what the entire fucking Open Comms Vegas broadcast is trying to give people a glimpse into what's going on out there. It's not about fucking, like, you know, high quality fucking topics or shit like that, whether or not fucking GigX did this or Judge fucking did that. It's got nothing to do with that. Although I will give you guys a fucking hint, Judge is going to be on the show.
Yeah.
But it will be fucking different. All right.
Do we need bodyguard detail for the show?
You know what? My understanding is fucking bodyguard details are going to be all over the place. Fucking security for this shit's been all got kinds of goddamn ramped up and all that kind of stuff. I will not have people in fucking suits behind me. I just won't do it.
Yeah,
and people in suits behind me? Like, what's wrong with men in suits?
Dude, if you want a fucking guy with a suit behind you, just fucking call. Yeah. I'll fucking throw my jacket
on. Make your boyfriend put a suit on, for
yeah.
fuck's sake.
Well,
Nanok
is saying,
I got my suit.
I'll go all kinds of fucking white collar on you.
Yeah. Nanok is saying Wolf Glenn should be on the show. He definitely would be, but he's not going to be in Vegas this year.
Oh, please. You all know Wolf Glenn has bought more than one fucking ticket to being on the goddamn show.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, he can fucking host
if
he wants.
If Wolf Glenn wanted to come on.
He's paid to host.
If Wolf Glenn wanted to come on audio at any time, he's more than welcome.
That's right. You front That's up right. like that, boom, you get bought in. But.
We're not so.
The show we do out
like,
there
we'll
is completely different than the show we do normally. Okay, it is really about trying to present fucking eVegas. Number one is positive light as we possibly fucking can, while kicking off what we believe to be the party of the fucking year, while celebrating Eve players and Eve developers and everything about fucking Eve. That's what Open Comms fucking Vegas is. So if you're looking for us to explain to you what the fucking minutes meant. Not that show.
Yeah, probably not even the Vegas show is generally never about any, like, you know, technical Eve stuff. It's all about what are we partying about? Who's had what
it's
encounters?
It's usually just a drunken shit show.
It is. It's literally just like we're partying on camera and you guys can enjoy it or not.
We tried. Like last year,
Yeah, actually, we kinda did.
Actually,
yeah,
that's
we
not
had...
true. I got Falcon on there like last year and
we
like,
had
right
Guard with
gate,
us.
Guard came on, question. Hunter came on, Avalon came on. We were
this
super excited.
I'm calling fucking dibs on Rain's mom who's gonna be there.
No, my mom? Artie
my
dibs.
Mom is so excited to meet you guys, by the
way.
She's so
my tongue girl this year. It's
Jesus
like, nah,
Christ.
You know, forget
no,
Art, girl. I'm not Art, kissing fucking.
No, Artie dibs on Rain's mom. She watches my streams, Derek. She watches your streams?
Yeah, she watches Drayden's stream. She doesn't watch me stream. She watches Drayden's
stream. Yeah, she doesn't even watch her own daughter's stream. She watches me stream. And
no,
Rain's,
I,
Rain's super
fun
jealous
of
Drayden's
favorite. Confirmed.
Yep.
Anyways, okay,
I've got dibs on Jintan's grandmother. Sorry.
Oh, man, we all forgot about Jin Graham.
Jin's not coming, but it would be funny as fuck if Jin Graham fucking showed up.
Jin
Graham. She'd be like, hi, Jin, I'm in Vegas. You poor bitch. Okay? But whatever.
I feel like Jin Tan's a lightweight. Like, Rain party with Jin.
No, Jin Tan. Well,
that would be fucking funny.
The funny thing is, like, we've been able to see the progression of Jin Tan's alcoholism skyrocket. Like, when he first came on the show, he was like, what, two shots in and hammered? And now Jintan's like half a bottle in. He's like, what are you guys going to start drinking that or what?
Every time he's on Open Comms, he's always like bobbleheading around. And like.
Yeah, because he drinks 10 times as much as the rest of us.
5 hours in front of us. He's like 5 hours ahead of our drinking.
Yeah, or super tired.
Oh,
all
right. That makes sense.
Like, Jintan has like developed the tolerance of like a Viking in no time flat.
But one of the things I do want to also, oh my God, this is all like fucking public service announcement right now, is the fact that, look, I'm throwing it out there in channel right now, so like you can click on this if you want. Just like the fucking Alliance tournament and all the fucking shitty ads that it has, the live eVegas stream will also allow you to contribute ads to that. Open Comms will be fucking having an ad for that, although it'll be after the fact of our show. But for those of you that
working
want
tomorrow.
You know, some fucking recognition for your alliance or whatever the fuck it is you have out there, it's like, make sure that you, you know, get a fucking advert put in.
Yeah. Cause I mean, it's the same format as the Alliance tournament. I don't know if anyone paid attention to the post that was made by the devs for the Alliance tournament, but it's all the same specs. It's, you know, got to be 1920x1080, 1:1 pixel ratio. It's got to be MP4 has to be.
Like, it is literally the same fucking specs.
Yeah. It's like, it's general stuff, but like H point. The one thing that threw me off when we were trying to make our stuff for the Alliance tournament was the H.264 audio codec, or not audio, but the compression codec. And I was like, I was super confused about what all that was, and then eventually
we
got
used
sorted.
The Russian compression codec, right? Because it's
no,
like,
we use some. It's basically like AA. You need to use like AAC or AVC. Or
no, we
like
don't
that.
Use North Korean because we know that's just going to be like out in like 3 months. But
yeah, I was because I'm like the funny thing is like I'm the guy in charge of all like the techie stuff for the show, but I'm like a super tech noob, so I always have to like Google anytime it's like okay, I got to do this. All right, time to go to Google because someone will know more about it than I do.
However, make a fucking advert, make a goddamn
yeah, 15
advert
seconds.
For the Eve Vegas
quick.
Live stream. It's like, whatever. Like, just throw some shit up on
the
fucking
wall. It's super
wall.
Easy. Like, look at the test
Literally,
advert for
throw
the...
some shit up on the wall.
Look at the test advert for the Alliance tournament. It's like, some chick is like, can I share something with her? You want to play spaceships with me? And then she does, like, a karate pose. Like, that... If someone
those are so funny. I love those
it's
ones
like, I mean,
where they're super cheesy and shit.
I like, the Alliance tournament ads are kind of funny, but, like, you cannot argue that they do not hold up to they what they were a few years ago. Back when you had, like, the Camel Empire... And
that is true.
The Camel War song, like easily top two. The other one that I'd put in the top two is the remix. I forget what Alliance it was. Was it it wasn't Hydra, but it was like the boom headshot, the boom headshot.
I think
my hands are shaking.
That's
boom.
Not as good like, as their screaming one though.
No. Like those two were like those two were the pinnacle.
That was
Every
Camel.
Oh,
now.
Yeah.
Come
yeah,
on
yeah.
Now.
Like, I mean, like the back then, the ads, like, that was the pinnacle of Alliance Tournament ads.
No, it wasn't
like,
the
you
pinnacle.
Do not
the
top
pinnacle. It was
the
not
pinnacle?
The fucking pinnacle.
I believe Jerry
right
just
now,
said
we
pinnacle.
Have been an upward
it's pinnacle.
Climb.
Pinnacle. Say pinnacle.
We have been on an upward
pinnacle.
Climb.
There's an E.
For
several Alliance Tournaments
not P.
now.
Pinnacle.
Right now, if you were watching
pinnacle.
This year's goddamn fucking Vegas stream, okay?
Pinnacle.
It will get better now. And then next year for FanFest, it will get fucking better. And for next year's
Drayden, even
because all of the fucking technology
Pinocchio,
and all of the creativity is just getting better.
Pinnacle.
However, what I will say about this year's fucking OpenComms fucking ad that will be there for fucking Vegas is, number one, it will be fucking low quality. Number two, it will actually represent the fucking show.
Mm. It'll also accurately represent Vegas. I think it represents of how players just get together, sit around, talk shit, usually not talking ever about Eve, and then they just hang out, have some shots, and have fun.
I need to fucking, like, lasso fucking Matterall, okay, who I know, like, I can, like, get for, like, 6 pesos an hour to, like, videotape people that are associated with OpenComms. Like, having conversations with, like, you know, the hoi polloi that are out there being like, oh my god, you're on open comms? You guys are the fucking best! Okay, that kind of shit. Alright. And then next year's fucking open comms video will be so much better.
Huh? Yeah. I really hope it's just Matterall filming people going, who the fuck is open comms? Or,
yeah, that'd be the
that
best.
That's even
work.
Better.
Wait, it's like, so what do you think about the open comms guys? Who?
Huh?
Yeah, who?
Yeah, that
exactly.
Like, we should use that.
Would make it even better.
Is that a
guys?
Corporation?
I'll do a fucking shot. Who are these guys?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that's what I need.
Oh,
I need
they get free alcohol? Okay, I'll go.
I'll do a
like,
shot.
You know.
Who are these guys?
Yeah, it's like that's actually like generally when we do the Vegas
fucking
show.
Fucking Laztel. Fucking Laz.
He's been here. Although.
I know, but he just highlighted my name. Therefore, I see.
Oh, he wants you to sign his tits.
Sign his tits. I've licked
his
beard.
I swear to God. I have heard
he won't let me sign his tits.
Not
going
to be there this year, and I swear to God, he's my like fucking hype date of guys that like are going to be there. And now, if he fucking highlights my name and says, "Nope, fuck it, the hurricane hit me, I'm not coming," I'm going to be
Although,
upset.
Yeah,
but
oh,
there it is,
the Wolf Glen secret donation.
I was already pre-poured.
We pre-poured.
All right, now, also, I will call, like, I know Wolf Glenn's watching now. Wolf Glenn, I sent you a whisper in Twitch chat. I hope you read it. Dirt needs your stuff to give you that shirt.
Yeah. Motherfucker owns
Ready?
This shirt. Like, honestly, yeah. If you want me to rub it on me or, like, you know, whatever.
Yeah, he can actually, like, rub it and not wash it and send it.
I can still physically rub it on me.
Shots.
I can take it to Vegas and rub it on all of us.
We could do that.
But
I'll give a Wolfman rub.
Just hit me with the can't make it motherfucker.
Oh, okay. He says he sent you the email.
I want to cough.
I swallowed that one wrong. Jesus.
That shot was actually for fucking Wolfman, so I won't cough it back up. But I'm gonna do a shot in a little while. I'm gonna cough it back into my shot glass because Laz said he's not fucking coming.
Sorry.
This is fucking terrible. Laz wasn't there for the last like conflict in the North. He's not coming to fucking Vegas. Fucking Noob Man's not coming to Vegas. There's like, multiple people that aren't fucking coming to Vegas this year.
Here's the real question. Is Bam Stoker coming?
He's not. I heard he wasn't.
Bam it. No?
I thought I saw it on, whatchamacallit, Twitter, that he wasn't coming.
I quit. Right. I quit. I'm not going to Vegas.
No, hold on a fucking second.
You muted.
It's like, there are people from Australia that can come or can't come to fucking Vegas. Okay? Bam Stroker's not one of those people. We expect fucking Bam Stroker to
Otto
come
Bismarck
to Vegas.
Says he believes he is.
I believe he is as well.
Maybe
that's
I'm
why
thinking
people
Otto
are fucking
said
throwing that out there.
Oh, man. I want to see Otto, too. I hope Otto goes. I don't know if he's going. I know it's super expensive. Australia's a long fucking way to go to Vegas. But
if Judge can make it there, he can't make it there on fucking Keepstar Isk.
Dude, the flight to Australia is like fucking 8 hours or some shit. Like,
I think it's more than that. You think it is from your place in
Canada? No, it's more than 8 hours. No. I think it's like a 14-hour flight.
Like 3 days from now, LA. That plane has to stay in the sky.
Yeah, no, I think it's like a 13 or 14-hour flight to Vegas from Australia, at least.
It was 14 hours for my girlfriend to fly from Toronto to LA to Australia when I flew her to Fiji. So it's probably like 10 hours, maybe?
To Australia, and then she went to Fiji?
It's long. I believe she had
one of those, like, you know, fucking, like, I have a layover in Australia. I'm not going to tell you about moments.
Oh, well, okay. Otto's flying to Sweden that week. What are you doing in Sweden that's more important
it's
than
probably,
Vegas?
Otto.
He's doing the Swedish bikini team thing, bro.
Okay, that's more important.
Anyway, that is actually. Holy shit, that really fucking kind of sucks because you know what? The EVE community has not actually seen an appearance from Laz in a while. And
Laz is going,
I'm telling you right now, and I know Elise knew this before tonight, but like Elise has been going, oh my god, I hope fucking Laz is coming.
Wait, Laz
and
is coming.
Whatever my fucking hand was doing had nothing to do with like what I actually meant, but I think it was true.
Wait, Laz is going though?
No, Laz just like said out there, I can't. All I read was I can't. Like, I skipped past everything after I can't.
Laz is not coming. Dirk was using a shake.
I feel like we should do a shot or a pour out or like.
Just like pretend to do a shot but throw it over
a shot
your
for like.
I'm not throwing a shot over my fucking shoulder because that makes nothing but a mess for my wife tomorrow
why
morning.
Just, that,
and
why
she has
pour
more
one
of
for
a mess.
CO2?
As, like,
it just wets my green
Nova.
Screen.
Like, a, but, like, pour out a 40 for CO2.
Well, a Vegas trip in... Okay. Laz is going to Vegas in November.
We did the whole fucking, like, you know, player ads thing, right? Player
just,
ads?
Yeah, we just
yeah,
did.
We did.
Now, if you're going to make a player ads thing, it should be like, why is Laz not coming to fucking Vegas? Why did we not go fund one of the E-Vegas fucking superstars of all time? That should be your fucking player ad video.
Yeah, Laz saved my
life. Where's
that? Laz saved my life in my first Vegas trip.
Do you remember that? You remember that.
I know you do. I do, yeah.
That
yeah.
time in the fucking hallway.
Yeah, Laz... No,
well,
he
died because I left and went to another party.
Yeah, well, yeah, but no, he saved my life because he fed me water. If I didn't have that water, I probably would have died before the ambulance got there.
I know.
Yeah.
This is why, like, Grath fucking heroes of the game need to be remembered.
He fed me water, quote Drayden. So, you know, like how everyone always shit talks Grath and they're like afraid of him IRL or whatever? All I remember with Grath from last Vegas was him sitting next to me going, man, this dude's really fucking annoying. I'm like, I know Grath. And he was just like so nice to me having a one on one super drunk talk at the Saturday night party.
Last year was funny because I went
everybody
like.
Everybody thinks Grath is a fucking Care Bear that mines fucking ice.
Okay, but like
you were
same
a dirty
thing.
Miner when you started.
Oh
so
man,
you can't
I didn't
judge people for that.
I didn't know it. Okay, this is new info. I'm always finding new info about that night. Apparently, Laz is saying that it wasn't just him. It was him and Darius Johnson that were feeding me water. Darius Johnson saved my life.
Look at the level of all the people hierarchy that said this guy should live.
This guy should live. We don't know who he is, but he should live. He's got a whole life ahead of him.
I gotta be honest. That was one of my worst blackout nights ever. Because my wife had 3 hours. 3 hours of fucking stories. She's like, oh yeah, you're standing there just like talking to people. And I'm like, really?
I remember this story.
She's like, oh yeah, we went down to another room. We were talking to people who founded eVegas. I'm like, really? Was there sausage? And I mean,
remember
like,
when the In-N-Out burger
sausage
showed up?
Or bacon?
Do you remember
the In-N-Out burgers that showed up in the suite?
No,
that
was
time.
The year before.
No,
that was the
wings.
Year before, dude. I'm talking about
my favorite story was like...
Year.
Oh, the lawn suite. Oh, God.
Lawn suite year was a completely different fucking dimension.
Those are some good burgers,
even
Walter.
What happened in the fucking goon suite the year afterwards with all that shit was like, that was a year where we grew and like recognized that what we're sweating right now is only like... part of the party.
It was a
the
super
fucking lawn suite the
the
year
lawn
before
suite party
was literally the most fucked
is that where
up
they, like, destroyed...
that Vegas will ever be unless
is that where they destroyed part of the suite
yes.
shit?
Yeah, yeah.
I actually passed out and they locked me in the lawn suite.
I was the
last one out and I woke up like 5:30 in the morning with nobody there.
They hauled me out like I only hear
fuck
stories
you,
but
dystopia.
I heard
I can't even respond to you.
I heard that they lit the mattress on fire. I heard that someone punched a hole in the wall. I did see someone Super Bowl touchdown spike a bottle of vodka on the kitchen floor. And then I heard
I think
that someone
was a friend of Elo Knight after Elo Knight got caught for fucking stealing booze.
there was in the bathroom there was like the toilet and the sink, but there was also
something
a separate
lit on
bidet.
Fire. I mean,
there was a comforter. There was
number one, we will never have more than the fucking lawn suite. Lawn suite goes fucking down in history.
Yeah. Like
I swear to God, you would have to burn down the next fucking building to beat them.
Yeah, but like the bathroom, like the toilet, and then you have this whole bidet bin, and someone just sat. Apparently, someone just took a giant dump in the bidet.
That's just a fucking given. If you have a fucking like ceramic fucking bowl that like shoots water one way or the other,
those poor maids. Yes, those poor maids. They came in the next day, and I'm sure they're just like, "You fucking kidding me?"
However. And this is where it all gets fucking crazy, right? eVegas is the fucking shit. There's goddamn, like actually, Matterall's one of those people who is like, you know, is always like, you know, we need to do a fucking, like, you know, history of what happened in EVE. I'm going to tell you right now, you know the fucking history that happened in EVE? eVegas became the fucking party of the motherfucking year. And you know what scares me? You know what literally fucking scares me about this fucking eVegas?
Spiders.
Fucking Vegas goddamn, like, you know, ruling on, fuck it, 420 blaze it, bitches.
Oh, right, yeah, it's legal.
Hey, want to give a shout out to Roannon, he's in chat. He's also an eVegas volunteer, so.
Roannon's volunteering this
we're
year,
doing
nice.
A shot
oh my god,
Roannon.
Yeah, let's do it.
Shot?
Yeah.
You're gonna fucking work, bro? I mean, it's like, come on, man. You've been through the Houston flood. You've been through, like, you know, all that. You've been through Vegas before, and now all of a sudden you're gonna, like, slave it out there?
Shots. And Mean Harry says hand jobs are great. I agree.
Can I tell you a story from this week at work?
Yeah, but it has to do with...
Okay, so it has to do with hand jobs.
It's Sylvester Stallone.
I got in my car one day, and I got out.
That hit the lung that still works.
I got my car like Wednesday and I noticed there was a spider on my rear view mirror and I'm like, oh, whatever. Like, he just wants to ride with me to work. Get out, go to work. Next day, I get in my car. I'm like, huh, that spider's not on the rear view mirror anymore. Get out of my car, see it crawl across my seat in my car. I close the door, go into work. And I'm coming out, check everything, no spider, call it good, go home.
Okay.
Friday. Today, I come out. Open the door, check everything, see no spider, sit down. I look over at my passenger. There's a fucking massive web in my passenger seat with the spider sitting there. I'm like, huh, at least he's like,
at least
not
the passenger got in and didn't notice the fucking web.
Right, well, so, I was more worried about him being around my seat, right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, but, so other spider story of the car. Man, this was like a few weeks ago.
I'm not done yet.
Off, bro?
So,
why are you fucking patronizing
her? So what I had to do,
goddammit?
I was like 15 to 20 minutes late to my meeting because I was catching this spider in a cup to let him go outside because I didn't want to kill him.
Shut the fuck up!
Kill that motherfucker! No, you kill it!
It was a nice, friendly spider.
Rain, you'll kill people.
You also had your man story of a spider.
I had my man story of Spidey. So no, this is actually a pretty girly story. Anyway, so. Not to be sexist, like, not saying girls are scared of spiders.
You didn't want to discount her fucking spider story.
Anyway, so I was driving, and I was like, this spider started crawling across the window.
Wow, and I was like, okay. 10 o'clock, by the way. We're only 1 hour in.
Yeah,
so a little girl. I will use any excuse to use the car.
But, like, I was like, okay, no big deal. But it was, I saw it, it was like, that's a hobo spider, which, like, that's a spider up here that's, it's... Not scientifically proven, but a lot of it's speculated that it has a similar venom to like a brown recluse. They haven't been able to confirm it medically, but like apparently, supposedly, if it bites you, injects you with venom, it might have the same necrotic effect that a brown recluse will have. So it, I was like, okay, so it's like they don't know,
why
but
do you
it's
call
like
it
still
hobo. Is that like a like does that have anything it, to do with how it
I
looks?
I think it's
a,
its actual name, but like it's nicknamed a hobo spider, aggressive house spider. It's all the same thing.
Hobo spiders are mean, aren't they?
Yeah, yeah. It's well, no, that's a misconception.
Like domestic thing.
No, it's
if a hobo spider lives in a house, is it really a hobo spider?
That's
well,
it's
not.
No,
really
no.
Oh. Hobo spider is like a spider.
So does a hobo spider?
No, no, no. But the thing is, like,
handkerchief tied around his shoulder.
It's a spider that's like only around in the Northwest U.S., but. It's a trapdoor type spider, and the thing is, the thing why people call it aggressive house spider is because it has horrible vision, but it likes to be in dark areas. And so when you're near it, if you cast a shadow on it, it will run towards you. And so people think it's like attacking them, but it's just trying to get hidden like underneath them. But the thing is, like,
it's like a horrible spider.
Horrible.
But the thing is, like, it's they think that the venom.
What if you put two of them together? Would it be like?
But the thing is, like, they think the venom is actually harmless.
They got on a fucking train and rode across America because they were looking for a better thing. I mean, like, would you call them a hobo spider?
No. I've been, I think, bit by a couple of them. Like, they give you a good welt. That like, it's about like, you know.
Hobo spiders are not known to be fatal to humans.
They're not fatal. No. They're not fatal.
It's not those caught by the brown recluse, and in severe cases, can take months to heal.
No. They're not lethal at all. But like, they generally will cause a welt like about this big on your leg for like about a week.
That's fine.
People so live it's through that it's shit. Shitty, but like, there's claims that they might be like they can cause necrosis, but it's never been documented. Anyway, aside from all that, I saw one of those crawling across my windshield. I'm like, oh, that's
so you're
fucked.
Saying it's not fucking bad. So why'd you freak the fuck out like a little
no,
bitch?
It can be bad. It's
which
shit.
I would have
it's,
done
it's
with
not
any
deadly
whatsoever.
It's not
whatever.
Deadly, but it's shit to get bit by. Anyway, so I stood crawling across my windshield and I was like, oh, that's fucked. And I looked, I'm like, oh wait, that's inverted. That's on the inside of the windshield.
Oh, okay. It's not blowing off right now.
I was like, okay, that's fucked. I was like, okay, but I'm driving at a stoplight, it's traffic, I can't. You know, because like, it was right overneath, like, my face. So it was like, if I try to smash it and it drops, it's going right into
smash
my lap.
It. No,
it's going,
number one, smash it.
No, it's you going right into my lap. I was like, I'm not
it.
Having that drop in my lap. I'm
Did
not,
you ask it if you could
I'm
smash
not
it?
Having my balls fall off because I want to kill a spider.
He didn't ask it because he's not fucking Canadian. Okay.
So,
oh man, I thought he was saying
smash. Like, smash a motherfucking spider in America, we'll just fucking do it.
But no, so I was like, I pulled over. Smash I was like, okay, now I'm ready. But the second I pulled
you
over,
you used a little bit of aggressive action.
I should have.
To be honest,
I should have.
I
didn't wear my axe that day. I was not in man mode.
Is afraid of spiders. It's fine.
I don't like spiders on me. If they're not on me, I don't.
Well,
really
no,
care
who
that
does?
Much. But
I don't
would
like
you like a black widow?
Like spiders building a fucking goddamn nest.
I
don't like spiders actually literally walking into my neighborhood and going, maybe. Fuck that shit. I will gas you.
I feel like spiders is code for something. Like
No. I've lived in Arizona. I've been around black widows a lot. They're scary.
Fucking redlining or any of that fucking shit. I'm going to tell you right now, if a fucking spider even comes on a tree near my house, boom, punch.
No, but the thing is, like, the second I stopped and I went to go smash it, it crawled up, like, where the windshield meets that, like, inside quarter panel, the spider crawled up and underneath that, and, like, it was underneath, like, the rubber gasket, so I was like, that's just inside the frame of the car now.
Fucking
it could come out
shit.
Anywhere.
Okay, this is where we in America can't let this shit fucking happen, right? Because
everything
otherwise
Australia
you end up like fucking Australia.
Everything
these
in
people
Australia
have
is
shit
yes,
that is
yeah.
like 4-inch fucking spiders out there that are fucking like reeling all over you. I mean, you can't let it
happen.
Oh,
yeah. No. When it comes to Australia, no one in the world has a right to bitch about any animal.
Fucking, like, you know, Otto and that shit, what they put up with out there, it's like, no.
Funnel web spiders, which are the friendliest spiders.
No. Funnel web spiders are one of the most...
Huntsman. If Donald Trump was talking about a fucking huntsman for spiders, it would be made of fire.
They're not friendly. Huntsman spiders are really defensive of their egg nest, and their bites are really painful. They're not poisonous, like, where they're, like, dangerous, but, like, they're really painful. But... Funnel web spiders are in Australia. One of the most poisonous, deadly spiders in the world, and they're giant. They're like the size of a big, giant tarantula, and they have fangs big enough and strong enough they can bite through a fucking
Donald
leather
Trump
boot into your
2020
foot.
2020 campaign.
And they love houses. They love hiding in houses. Like, fuck that. And they have the redback spider, or whatever it is, that likes to hide in laundry and is super deadly. They have the jack jumper ant, which is like one of the most painful ant bites ever. That loves to live in backyards. They have deadly snakes, deadly crocodiles, like the biggest crocodiles,
fucking show.
Biggest concentration of great whites. Everything
show
wants to kill you in Australia.
Will admit to listening to this show by fucking checking up in the channel and shit like that. But I'm gonna tell you right now, if people from fucking FanFest brought the fucking spiders from their goddamn countries to your volcano land, you would be shitting things. You would be fucking karma banning players over what they did.
Iceland spiders are literally garden spiders. That's like the only type of spider they get. And I've literally, when I was in Iceland for AT, I was like, oh, a spider. Poke, and it would just like run away on its web.
What do you think when fucking Judge brings one of those goddamn 8-inch spiders up to your goddamn country? What are you going to do then? Yeah, you're going to fucking ban him, because that's right, exactly what you should have done. Don't let that shit onto your fucking continent, because I'm going to tell you right now, it only freaks your wife out.
Yeah. All of a sudden, like, Otto lives with the most dangerous shit in the whole world. Like, everywhere he turns, he's looking at death in his country. And he's fine with it. Like, I mean, like...
Like a red tip.
I would say
it.
Australians
like
are the hardest motherfuckers in the world because of the wildlife.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Yeah,
I didn't either. Yeah. Well,
okay.
I was only light fingering my fucking controller.
You were just fingering it a little bit?
I was giving it the fucking edge of my goddamn thumb. And it's like, you know, look, if you want the full thumb, I'll give you the fucking full thumb.
That's not that exciting.
I was commenting about that fucking, like, giant lipstick thing that fucking drunk Canadian has in his goddamn hand that looks like
a
giant L'Oreal.
A dog lipstick?
We're not going into the dog aspect of this.
What's wrong with my Victor?
I did not mention dog penis.
Wait, why is it not red now? Why is the tip not red?
L'Oreal container.
Wait. DC, why is the tip not red? Is it not excited?
No, I don't turn it on. It's fine. I'm a pretty ugly human being, so I
wait,
get
no. The tip was red before. Now it's not.
Are you sure? Should all be ugly fucking human beings in this game. That's how we keep it in game, by being ugly human beings.
That's how I do it.
I mean, on the outside. You can be an ugly human being on the inside.
Well, you know what? I'm going to be totally fucking honest. I think
I'm going to one-up
all
you
get
and
our
go
fucking
both.
Ugly on.
Look, I took the tip off my vape because you were making fun of it, and I'm super self-conscious.
Wait, no,
did it
you,
glow?
No. Like, judging by the girth of the tip of your vape.
Whoa, Twitch.
Just saying, judging by the girth of your tip of your vape, you
what
added,
are you implying?
You added a prosthetic tip to it. You
what
did not
you
take away
about the girth of it.
I'm just saying, you added a tip. You didn't take away. You added
you
a tip.
You need a big vape?
No, you just...
You
know, I'm just saying, like, you enhanced
you want a big
your
hit,
vape.
Drayden. You want to see what I was like back in the day? You want a big fucking hit?
Wait, are you
yeah,
saying
yeah.
Your vape has shriveled over time?
No, my vape is, like... My vape is just mediocre. My vape is, you know, big enough for me. That's
I mean,
that's
hey,
all
have,
I care about.
They have pills for that. You know what I mean? You can make it big.
No one tells me that I need a big vape.
Really? Because I'm pretty sure no one tells you anything about your vape because you don't have a girlfriend.
I listen to my vape over you.
Okay.
Are you guys fucking arguing about who's more vape nation than the other?
No,
we're
making a really shitty metaphor and comparing vapes to dicks.
Yeah, but, yeah. If you didn't,
hi,
if you didn't notice,
hi,
Rain,
I'm drunk Canadian.
I'm arguing with the Amamake police because they think if you go on a date with someone, that means you have to fuck them, and now we're all arguing about it.
Wait, they're saying I scared away Laz. Maybe I did.
F.
Riff. Like, yeah.
When,
like,
will custom open common vapes be a thing? After we
Type F in chat to show respects for Laz disappearing because I chased him off, apparently. Yep. F's. F's all around. F's for shots, because that stands for shots.
You said Q, right?
Yes.
Alright. I threw Q in chat.
And, yep. And H.
Essentially, type something in chat. Anything at all.
Anything.
Are we doing a giveaway?
What? No.
Are we? Whatever.
I don't know.
We can.
Damn it, Dirk.
Do we want a giveaway?
I don't know. You're
we
like,
can.
Type shit in fucking chat. It's like.
Oh, no. I was just saying.
Don't, like, we only ask that when we're going to do a giveaway?
Oh, okay. Shoot,
see, now
goes.
Actually somebody has to do a fucking
giveaway. Wait,
why
are we doing a giveaway?
We're not, but we might be. But.
Why
Shooter,
people,
Shooter
like,
just
type shit in chat?
Shooter just put, well, because Laztel left chat and they blamed me for it, so they said type F.
Laztel left chat? He
I don't,
left
well, last, they said type F.
I had a Laztel comment to make before, like, has he left chat?
Well, it's gone, it's, the chat's
over.
I
went over, I fucking grabbed my dick and I fucking, like, took a piss and I'm like, I was thinking about Laztel while,
like,
I was doing
it. I get to highlight the fact that you grabbed your dick
full-fisted? Or did you just, like, do, like, the
no,
two,
I did
the two-finger tap,
pinch.
The two-finger top touch.
No, I did the fucking white man fucking, like, you know.
You do the pinch? I don't
the
do the pinch.
Man.
I just do the
three.
I just do, like,
I think I had a thumb on the head, but
no,
like,
no.
You know,
yeah. I just do, like, the top touch just to aim, because, like, the pressure aims up. You got to aim down. That's the trick. Anyway, Shooter McLoads is spamming my face in chat, so we have to do shots.
Oh, Jesus.
You know what? You'll just fucking take a shot from anybody. I gotta be honest.
I will.
Like, some of us need
what?
To fucking.
Dirk, some of us are shot sluts, okay? And we just like shots, okay?
I know, I get that. You know, I'm totally for fucking doing the thing that's called, but like.
Don't open that
honestly,
door.
You need to fucking, like, you know, hold back once in a while and be like, really?
What's wrong
me?
With taking shots?
Have some fucking shot pride.
I am. I'm doing Tito's. I haven't busted out the fireball like someone I know.
You know what? I got
without
some fireball
shot
in the fucking garage.
But...
I would have to, like, walk upstairs out to the fucking garage and get it, but don't think it's not there. However, I do believe I need to reel us the fuck back.
You might have to, because we've gone so far
there
off
was
track.
Actually, there was actually this week, if I can pull it up here, no, submissions. No, fuck submissions. Nobody's into submissions right now. The mega blog. The mega blog from fucking Falcon, which I'm posting out into the fucking channel right now. Well, it was part of, you know, it was part of how fucking eVegas sold out, which actually, when I fucking saw that, number one, I knew that eVegas sold out. It's not the first fucking time they used that. But in the whole wake of last week, right, it's like, I created this whole fucking meme about, like, what do these two things have in common? And I put the eVegas logo up and the fucking judge's face up. And I said, they both sold the fuck out. But that was actually kind of funny. But it was actually funnier than what this mega blog was actually good for. Some of it we actually talked about earlier tonight, which is how you fucking check in and the fact that fucking tickets are sold the fuck out, except for those CO2 people who actually followed through with threats themselves and got booted the fuck out of coming to Vegas, and therefore it opened up some of the people that were out on the wait list. Checking in eVegas, nope, we checked that fucking shit 11 a.m. on fucking Friday, motherfuckers. If you're not there, fucking get in line.
Hold on. So with the eVegas thing, I didn't know this, but Noisy Gamer is saying that CCP Siegel will not be in Vegas this year.
All right, let's go through.
I did not know that. She's been in every eVegas I've been to.
And this is purely fucking hearsay. This has nothing to do with what I have fucking heard on the fucking seriousness level. Or what may have happened back in the fucking day. Okay, number one, we all know that CCP Siegel was in charge of EVE prior to being the executive producer. However, at the fucking time, I believe that she was also out on fucking maternity leave then. I believe she is also out on maternity leave now. She's got like fucking 6 months of this shit, okay? I do not believe
well, that's
that we
a
will
valid
see
reason,
fucking
though.
Siegel. look, as somebody who loves fucking chatting to fucking Seagull behind the fucking scenes and whatnot about Eve, okay, it sucks she's not going to be there this year. That means I have to look fucking Fozzie in the fucking face and be like, bro, seriously? Okay.
Wait,
what's wrong with Fozzie? I like Fozzie.
Nothing's wrong with Fozzie.
What'd you say about Seagull, Dirk?
She's not being at base.
She's on maternity leave.
Okay. I'm so glad that like, they said that because like it was so she was like super pregnant while we were there for AT and like I was talking to her about like having a child. Yeah, so she's like getting ready to have a kid and apparently in Iceland. So like this was like the most interesting thing I found out about Iceland. But you can like wait a whole month before naming your child. We were like, oh, like, do you know if it's a boy or a girl? Like, what are you going to name it? And she's like,
I waited an entire fucking month before naming my daughter.
You have to name your child before you leave the hospital in America.
Yeah, that's interesting. In Iceland, you don't have to.
Yeah, now, and like, I thought it was so cool.
If waited a month before naming her daughter McGurk Jr., that's where I'd give some fucking credit.
Wait, she's not, I guarantee you she's not naming her kid McGurk Jr.
She's not. We all know that, right? But we all know that without even having confirmation, we know that. The spasms that take place during childbirth and like you know, all that kind of shit. She's probably not going to be at fucking Eve Vegas, right? So all you people who are coming to Eve Vegas going, oh shit, I hope I fucking talk to Seagull. Chances are, unless they fucking fly her around in the fucking CCP Learjet, not coming.
No, right. Okay. Like it makes sense though. I did not know she was pregnant. Actually, I didn't know at all.
I'm not saying anybody did. I'm not saying it's actually true. I may have been led the fuck on.
Well, Rain just said she was there for the Alliance tournament. And she was pregnant. Well, so it Rain is
she,
true.
Yeah, you said she was on maternity leave. So yeah.
Yeah, I just
and
I
mean, I Carker.
Rain, were you a midwife for a CCP dev's child?
No, I just talked to her at, like, lunch one time. Because I hadn't had the chance to talk to her.
We're on the same fucking hearsay thing, right? Okay.
I mean, maybe
she just, like, had gained a bunch of weight and she was, didn't want to tell me. And so yeah, she was like, no, fuck, I doubt it.
I was surprised because...
Did you look at her and go, oh my god, are you pregnant? Or were you like, oh, hi.
That's always a risky... Well... I find that
very
women
risky proposition.
Like this
that
is
would
not
be, like totally uncool at Vegas. People, look, if you see a fat person at Vegas, do not ask if they're a fucking dude who's fucking pregnant.
I'm just saying, like, I this is not a sexist statement. But I feel like women have a better intuition of like people say like they have this glow. I don't see the glow.
No. So when dudes see a chick who's overweight, it may look pregnant, it may look not. Whereas when chicks,
her fucking eyes,
when chicks see a pregnant chick versus a fat chick, you kind of it's really easy to know the difference.
Well, how you know your body carries weight when you're pregnant. There's times where we're like,
I had a glow. You guys don't remember that. Most of you motherfuckers don't remember.
No,
back when my fucking daughter was ready to be fucking born,
black light paint on your face.
We weren't on Twitch.
Yeah. No, but anyway, like, I'm just saying, like, before they actually, like, when they physically show you, you can kind of tell, like, are they fat or are they pregnant? Like, I can kind of tell that difference. I'm saying,
rubbing fireball on your forehead is not glowing. Just
no. Well, yeah.
Fireball burns, so therefore it glows.
I'm just saying, like, before it even physically shows, there are times where I'm like, you're pregnant. And it's like, how the hell did you guess that? But, like, I can't do it. Like, I mean, and there's...
What none of you know...
My brother...
And this is actually
my brother's wife. Like, she's having a kid...
fucking thing for open comms.
Oh.
Fozzie is glowing as well.
Oh, he's having a kid?
I didn't say that. I didn't deny it. But what I'm saying is the man is glowing.
Who's glowing? You're glowing?
Fucking Fozzie. And therefore, Fozzie Sav is also glowing.
Somebody decided to procreate with that thing?
I'm just saying, it's like, I mean, like, my sister, like, my brother's wife, like, she is now super pregnant, but like, I mean, like, back in the...
Oh, your sister's not fucking glowing, right?
Is there a difference between
not
regular pregnant
my,
and super
my sister-in-law,
pregnant?
My older brother's wife, is having a kid in December, but they had a whole thing, like, earlier this year... And there's like this whole, it was like something for Easter. They did some scavenger hunt. I'm like, what am I, like 12? And they did this thing. It's like, okay, you look in the oven. I'm like, I don't get it. And then you open the oven, there's a hamburger or a hot dog bun in there. I'm like, okay.
Who has a hot dog bun?
Well, there's
a girl.
Well, they're like, there's a bun in the oven. And I'm like,
but not a hot dog bun. There's not a fucking cock in the oven. I mean, it's like, what?
No, like they. Apparently that's a phrase, like it's a saying. There's a bun in the oven. They look like there's a bun in the oven, and I was like
a fucking like hot dog or vagina shaped bun.
Well, hold on, I'm just saying. I looked at it. I was like,
you wouldn't need a vagina shaped bun.
I don't get it. I don't get it. Apparently, a bun in the oven means there's a baby in the womb, but I was like, it's a phrase. It's a phrase. I've never heard it before. So I looked
at so far off what we're supposed to be.
I looked at them confused. I was like, I don't get it. I don't get it. And they're like, no, there's a baby.
I'm going down the checklist here.
Yeah. So I was just like, I was super confused. I was like, oh. And they told me like that means like she's pregnant. I'm like, oh.
Even I sometimes say when I say oh. And I go, nope,
not today. No. I say, oh, oblivious to a lot of shit. You have no idea how much shit I'm.
Oh my god, Drayden, I'm trying to like, you're my foil, right? Like, whatever. Okay.
Well, like, I mean, like, what kind of foil? Like, Reynolds Wrap or like Western Family?
The eVegas schedule. The eVegas schedule has also come out this week. I will actually myself copy and paste it out there into the fucking channel. Paste as text. No, literally just fucking paste. Okay. It's like the schedule for the fucking like things came out and you know, this is actually kind of fucking cool because number one, we know if you're fucking cool, you get in on Wednesday and you think that you're going to do that fucking touristy fucking thing with like, you know, whoever you brought out there, but you're not because Wednesday is now actually fucking late. If you want to do a fucking touristy thing, come in on fucking Tuesday. But if you come in on Wednesday, we're going to be like, oh shit, you know, yeah, you just got here. Fucking have a shot. Let's go. All right.
That's what happened to me.
Thursday when Rain rolls in and has her fucking, like, you know, vegan fucking meal at whatever fucking
place. It's gluten-free! It's
gluten-free! Well, that means no vegetables, right?
Burger,
no, wait.
Wherever the fuck it is she has at whatever restaurant she rolls into. Okay? And then Thursday night, we roll into the fucking open comm show. Okay? And I'm gonna tell you right now, until CCP changes it otherwise, open comm show is literally the I am a cool EVE player and showed up for this shit ahead of time. If they can, like, pull some manic velocity, I was acting on stage fucking shit, they can do that. But the open comm show will start this shit. I don't give a fuck if we have to get there the Sunday before. We will be the first fucking thing that ever happens in this entire goddamn engagement. However, and then there's Thursday and there's Friday. Friday, we have the opening ceremony. We have the fucking keynote address, which I think is fucking outstanding, right? Do that shit on Friday. Fucking play it out on fucking Friday. Don't wait for us to also play it out. But, and CCP Presents, which is their idea of whatever it is they're gonna fucking present.
Back that's in the probably day, them. No, that's hopes for that. That's them saying it's something probably OPSEC, but they're not going to say what.
No. They have got the 1600 position, 4 o'clock in the afternoon position, of what they present. And quite honestly, it's like, you know what? I hope they present the fucking world. I don't want them to present things that don't exist, but like honestly, they need to fucking come up with something. They need to give fucking hope to the fucking audience.
Always the opening is always, you know, Falcon and Guard. They come out for that hour and just hype. Yeah, welcome, great. This is what we've done. This is where we're going. This is what we do. And yeah, I don't think they've kind of presented a lot in that keynote in the recent years. They've kind of already pre-announced a lot of that stuff. And this is not going to be, I don't see anything earth-shattering coming, but I don't have any OPSEC stuff what they're going to talk about. But, I mean, what do we got? What do we got coming up? I don't know besides structures and, you know, mining stuff.
I am so always excited. Oh, go ahead, Ray.
They might talk about what's going to be coming out in the October Lifeblood release. I've hinted at what's coming out with that with, like, the Winter Expansion. Maybe it's more details about that or maybe more specifics. And then we've also, I think Falcon tweeted about having Spark, Valkyrie Warzone, and then like EVE Online obviously playing, kind of thing. And I know we asked him about Nova, Project Nova. So I'm really hoping that they come out with something about that, but I don't think they will. They're shaking his head. Yeah, you guys are shaking your heads.
Well, I'm shaking my head. Yeah. Only but I think you'll see Spark and Valkyrie. Day, probably... What can we expect out there? Can we expect Valkyrie fucking VR? Can we expect the non-VR version? And they, you know,
Valkyrie's always VR. It's always VR.
Look, number one, you can expect all of it. The fucking VR version, the non-VR version, as well as Spark.
They just run the Valkyrie tournament. They always run VR. They have a 3v3 VR setup.
They have the last few years because that's the only thing.
But why would they go to non-VR if... Like, why
because
would you...
that's what they're introducing now.
Oh, for the people who get like motion sickness.
Talked about on prior shows.
I don't listen to shows though.
I know you don't listen to what we do here. Okay, but they're going to have fucking both. They're going to have the VR version as well as the non-VR version of fucking Valkyrie. And they're also going to have Spark. And actually, quite honestly,
I don't even know what Spark is.
Spark is their
it's a virtual reality sports
VR
game
that has gloves and
V
shit.
Sports. It's called like V Sports.
Like
so
boxing?
It's like Tron.
Oh my God,
no.
Stuff.
It's like Tron. No. Like you throw a ball and it has to like, you know, hit your opponent or whatever.
Yeah, you have you can put a shield
up.
Gloves. It's a and you have gloves.
Is it like
you can
ricochet?
Catch the ball, you can
like
deflect the ball. Shut
up. I mean, it will
you throw
ricochet.
It. You can do anything. You dodge it, you roll around, you know sniff the other dog's butt, you know, that kind of thing. It's
oh,
really
man,
cool.
I'm totally
you
sold
no
out.
If you have no hands, you can't play Spark.
Correct. It's very non-accessible friendly.
So this is not going to let...
made last week.
Gommel play.
Because Judge would not be able to play Spark.
Yeah, you need hands.
Oh, no.
Everybody thought that it had to do with other things.
Does it need hands or arms?
It had to do with his ability to play Spark.
Hands or arms?
If you have no hands, you can't play Spark, bro.
But arms, if it's just like where arm
no,
motion...
No, there's no fucking stubbing your way through Spark.
You can't stub the star? I mean...
You I cannot. Mean, and that's why, like, people were actually
stub the spark
of the whole virtual reality thing that GigaX was trying to say. He's like, look, I won't let you get on their fucking, like, you know, Spark game. I won't let you do it.
Oh.
That's what he was trying to say. He was like, before all this... This is all virtual reality. And it's why people don't understand what GigaX is trying to say.
Duct tape the controllers to the stubs.
Exactly. You can't duct tape that shit.
Chendao.
Oh, wait,
shit.
Wait.
Trying to get
holy
all
shit, it's Chendao. Dude.
Like, whatever. You didn't
Chendao
understand
my bro.
The fact
What's
that
up,
fucking
man?
GigaX knew what was coming down with VR.
I hope Chindo's going to Vegas
again.
He was
ahead of the game.
Me and Chindo
he
hung out.
He was ahead of the fucking game.
Me and Chindo,
one of my favorite people.
No, me and Chindo hung out
he,
like for an entire
honestly,
night Las Vegas.
Like
it was amazing.
One of your
it was so
like,
good.
You know, heroes.
We saw a random British guy get taken away by costume wearing vagabonds, and we just you know what we speculated on his fate.
Can
and
you
we're
guys
like, you know
read
what?
Chat for me right
He'll
now?
He'll probably
like,
be all right.
I said all that shit. Can you read
oh,
chat?
Oh damn.
Me?
Well,
Dirk, no one heard you.
Can you be like, Dirk's a dick? Just say it three times and I'll go away.
That's not
Don't
how
say
it works.
It
it's
times.
Beetlejuice and
That's
you
Beetlejuice.
Get summoned.
Right. Chindao
but
is
it doesn't
not
make
coming
things go
this
away.
Year,
make
sadly.
Your show up.
All right, I'm doing a shot. I'm doing
but
a shot
anyways,
because Chindao's not
like,
coming.
Honestly, this whole
have,
fucking...
No, Chindao!
Yeah, he's not coming.
Sad face emotes in chat.
Chindao is fucking awesome.
When we begin to come in with the whole fucking like you know thing of what's going down out there, look... I'm going to be completely 100% honest, right? I've said this for the last fucking couple of years. EVE is fucking background for EVE Vegas, right? And I honestly fucking believe that again this year. I don't have to get up until fucking, no, that's not true. Fucking Saturday after the fucking, like, pub crawl. I got
to
get up at fucking 10 a.m.
Did you already link the
I
schedule?
I have to get up at fucking 9 a.m. to be there for the fucking CSM roundtable. Okay? That's fucking
wait,
hard.
Wait, 9 a.m.
How
at the CSM
roundtable?
How do you roll
a fucking roundtable at
9 a.m. on a
10
Saturday? 10 a.m. on Saturday? Saturday,
10 a.m. Saturday.
Yo, not going.
CSM roundtable.
No. Not going.
I know you say that right now, but you know that your ass will be hanging in the back of the fucking stadium what are the fucking CSM going to say?
God damn. Only if I can show up in sweatpants, I'll definitely. What? I have to look professional?
No, not professional. The only dress code
says. Sweatpants. I want to wear sweatpants.
The dress code says
wear tight ass fucking yoga shorts.
I'll wear my space pants.
You could do that. The dress code said anything but sweatpants.
God damn it.
However, how do they fucking...
Sorry, that's what... I'm just the messenger.
Trying to bury the fucking lead, okay? CSM Roundtable, 10 a.m. Saturday. You know what? I'm going to tell you right now. If you're one of those bitches who wakes up at the fucking early chime of fucking morning...
I'm not going there.
Fuck yeah, fucking Friday morning.
No bullshit.
It means you didn't get fucked up enough...
I'm not going there, Derek, because you know what?
It means you didn't get fucked up enough the night before.
I'm not going there because...
Is it going to be people from the CSM? So is it going to be Steve? And it's going to be...
Steve?
Judge.
A nominee's going, the motherfucking judge.
I'm not going there because...
Who else from the CSM is going?
Literally fucking nobody, because they're all fucking Brits and like people from other fucking countries. Like, you know, shit that doesn't matter.
I'm not going there because I am not a big fan of round tables.
What he fucking looks like.
I'm not a big fan of round tables, and the CSM puts me to sleep. So you put those two together. But I'm just going to like lay down in the corner and sleep in the corner of the room.
If you've ever counted yourself as a legitimate fucking Eve journalist,
have I ever?
Wake up that morning.
When did I do that?
You have to say, you know what? What if Aerith showed up and said, yeah, this is me, motherfuckers. I'm here to talk on American soil.
I'm here to listen to Max Singularity's...
What if Aerith was wearing a fucking MAGA hat at Eve Vegas?
If he wore a MAGA hat in Vegas, I would take a shot with him, and I would tell him...
Not one of those fucking gin
fucking
masks.
No. I would tell him, like, you know what? I'm not listening to your round table the next morning. I'm going to listen to the Max Singularity's fucking space post.
Because that's always really good.
And then I'm going to listen to, like, the structure stuff. I'm going to listen to the whatever stuff.
I do want to give a fucking shout-out. I do want to give a shout-out to my man. It's like, look, if I got to wake up at fucking 10 a.m. and go out there and listen to the fucking CSM talk a bunch of shit that we all know does not fucking matter, and let's say talk about the fucking metagaming of what happens at the fucking CSM, fuck that shit. Everything after that, poor Mike Azariah has been cramped into 10:30 to 11. Doesn't matter. Everybody who fucking cares will be off at the fucking CSM thing. All right? Shipyards and the future of PvE, resource wars. Honestly, nobody gives a shit, okay? And then we get to the continuum of war. Matterall's presentation.
What was the first name? Did you remember what CCP put on the schedule for Matterall's speech?
Matterall's thing was
heavy metal meta.
No, it was heavy meta.
What?
It was heavy meta. They didn't add the L
heavy
for metal.
Heavy metal meta. It had nothing to do with Metallica. It had nothing to do with what you would consider to be heavy metal. And even Matterall is like, I'm borderline meta.
Matterall, 12 noon, Saturday.
Matterall, like, flinched back and said, oh my God, bitches, don't say this. I'm not that cool. And it became Continuum of War, which is about how the meta, the actual, like, meta of ship changes has changed over the course of the last few wars, which is actually fucking cool because it's not just about, you know, what, how the fucking meta of all this shit has changed from, like, being 1,000 people to 100 people to, like, what, 5 motherfuckers sitting in a fucking diner saying, this is how we gauge what is going to happen in our game. Because they're bitches and we let them be bitches. Because you're bitches that are at a sub-level of letting them be bitches.
I guess we're bitches.
Shots?
Wait, that's poor.
But that's Saturday.
Sarge, you gotta slow down.
Saturday is the
fuck
noon,
this slow down shit.
Yeah, noon is the...
Because I'm ready to race through fucking Eve Vegas.
No, you don't want to race, don't race through it. Through, you want to savor it. You want to enjoy it, Dirk.
Yeah, but but I think the other one we got to catch is at the 1400 at 2 o'clock is the community and tournament roundtable, right? That's where we're going to be at after
really
that one.
That is really a fucking tough one. That's a tough one, because, okay? Because that back in the day used to be everybody. From fucking podcasters to fucking people who were writing about Eve. It actually used to be about the community that was related to Eve that was willing to report to you people out there. But I'm going to be honest. In the last year or so, that shit has not been the fucking same. It has been about people who are like, no, we're the community. Fuck that shit. You're not the fucking community. You are like... You are lesser beings who are not being fed to by the fucking community. And I'm not saying that in a fucking facetious sense. I'm totally being fucking serious. What we feed you as the fucking Eve media is really actually what you need to be fed.
We're like the Fox of New Eden.
No.
With a mix of CNN,
I believe that,
and NBC.
I believe that we have in the fucking Eve media Fox.
Yes.
MSNBC and CNN, right?
Like, we
I
are
believe
what
that we have all these things.
I, whoa!
Well, I'm the rover.
Whoa! Whoa! What? Wait! What? Wolf Glenn, Wolf Glenn dropped again.
What?
Wolf Glenn tipped $50.
Wolf Glenn just dropped another $50.
Heavy meta shots.
Okay, yeah, we'll do heavy meta shots for. Yeah, Wolf Glenn just dropped another $50 on us. So,
would you guys be mad if I sat there and said, "Fuck you, Wolf Glenn"?
Wait, would you be mad if I lost my Tito's Oh, no, here it is.
I would not be mad if you lost your virginity.
No. I've done that before. I've done that before.
I feel bad.
You haven't done it twice,
like, all these E-Vegas.
I would love to do it twice. Well, the thing is, like, it's so fast. Like, doing it twice would be like...
Twice?
You know, you combine the two, it's like 30 seconds.
Rain. Reel it back. Rain. Pull it back.
I'm never going to get to my fucking, like, stretch out.
It's like, am I in? Yes. Okay, I'm done.
Drayden, what hair did you... Drayden mentioned during the week that he got a bunch of fucking hair cut off during the weekend and he lost like 8 pounds. And it's like,
yeah,
honestly...
You said you were like, my hair is shorter than... My hair is longer than yours,
yeah,
Drayden.
Yeah, yeah,
and I'm like, what the fuck?
Oh, yeah, I'm totally a skinhead right now. But,
yeah,
like,
well,
you're
no,
not.
It's...
You're still totally the same fucking guy.
No, it's because, like, if my hair is longer than, like, half an inch, it's too
Dirk's
long.
Pubes. Yeah.
Yeah, well,
wait,
you don't trim
them?
Dirk, come on.
Dude, I am a fucking bald shaver, I'm going to be honest, because it's like...
Manscaped.
You're like, a bald shaver. Oh, I don't do that.
It's not even about fucking manscaping. It's about, like, me and my wife being like, fuck you.
Yeah.
We both love bald.
Yeah.
But...
Yeah. I do too.
On the other hand, when you said I shaved off 8 pounds of my fucking hair...
I used my... Well...
And yes, motherfuckers, if you want to actually fucking know about it out there while you're fucking listening right now,
like,
yes,
choking?
We both prefer fucking clean. I want to lick all of it, not just in it, but
fucking
around
dirty?
It and all that kind of
just,
shit.
Like, water,
E-Rocks,
you
know what I mean? E-Rocks, it was me.
Canadian guy, nobody cares because honestly, really, Canadian, we all know you guys are hairy up there. You guys are hairy
quite
north
the opposite,
of the border,
actually.
Motherfuckers.
Nope, they're not.
What the opposite?
Really? Are you guys fucking, like, Jamaicans? Fucking, like,
holy shit. Would you have hair?
Pearl has lost 60 pounds since Las Vegas.
Fuck plus this shit. I'm not walking out
the tree
there
looked,
this
hey,
year
hey,
fucking
hey.
Kissing a hot Pearl.
The tree looks
but
a lot
Pearl
taller.
Was
no
my
bushes.
Guy last year.
I saw Pearl a few months ago. He did look pretty good, man.
I agree, DC.
I saw Pearl a few months ago.
If
like,
he looks
you
good
can't
this
deny
year,
Pearl.
I'm not kissing him. Fuck that shit.
But no, I mean.
Pearl, I'll kiss ya.
This is what has messed me up about what's gay and what's not about Eve. Us ourselves, right? I mean, because, like, I kissed a guy last year.
He did.
Wait,
yeah.
Who
yeah.
Did you kiss?
He kissed Pearl.
Who'd you kiss? Who'd you kiss?
Fine, Dirk. You like
Pearl.
The dick.
Pearl.
Fine.
It was Pearl.
And huh?
Dirk, look. Who'd you kiss?
Rain, it's Pearl.
Fucking Pearl. Fucking
Pearl. Fuck, I met Pearl.
Like,
no, they tongue kiss. It was right behind you, Rain. It was like, it was literally right behind you. You were sitting
okay,
at the...
Okay, was I talking to Manic Velocity
right
or Guard?
Her,
you were, like, smitten with, someone.
It was Manic Velocity, right?
Yeah, probably.
Like,
yeah,
like Manic, just like his blonde hair and like.
Yeah, you're just like. Oh!
I promise. This
and
year,
Dirk behind you, Dirk right behind you, was
like making out with dudes and shit.
No, no, no. Yeah, it was full tongue action. Like they both like tongued each other into like their tonsils. It was like it was tonsil massage.
Whoa, now.
Yeah, no, it was Dirk. I looked closely because I was jealous.
I'm not telling them my fucking tongue was not literally on his fucking molar.
Sadist.
Okay. However,
it was. I mean,
he was reluctant.
Sadist just donated 25.
He was reluctant.
Who did?
I don't want to say I raped
Sadist.
Sadist donated 25. However. Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm a porn star. Okay. Thank you, Sadist. Oh,
get a
thank
grip
you.
On your shit, Drayden.
CCP
Jesus
Ghost.
Christ.
Actually, is CCP Ghost going to be at Vegas? Yeah. Can we hear that?
Ooh.
Well, I'm just saying.
Now there is a man I could really.
There's a guy who's already ripped off tomorrow.
Thank you, Blaster, for catching that, because you know what? The Imperium does not put sounds with their notifications anymore, so I have to be vigilant to see them, and I didn't see that one because I was looking elsewhere.
Oh, so you as the streamer should be vigilant.
I have to be completely vigilant.
Number one,
non-stop.
Unless you are Astriothy, okay, or fucking like.
Well, there's a reason they turn the sounds off is because there's like some there's some follow bot, so like we get a follow like every 30
Astaroth.
Seconds to a minute.
Unless you're Astarothy or the fucking Mind Clash podcast. Number one, your dick should not be so hard over a fucking one CCP dev. So therefore, we should be able to cut off the fucking dev dick that happens in this fucking game.
Where are you going
okay,
with this?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so I'm just saying, like, they turn the sounds off because there's some weird follow bot that's not in our control that is, like, sending random follows to our channel, like, every 30 seconds. So, like, the sound would get annoying. So they turn the sounds off, which is good for that, but the bad because now I can't get an audio notification
that
someone donated.
Why are you trying to hide my home over?
But, Sadist, thank you.
It's okay to be wait.
All right, so Sadist, thank you for the 25, and he says, now you get to kiss Pearl and have a shot.
Last year, my life with fucking Pearl during that fucking moment was something that every fucking like, gay person in the world should be like, you know what, I'm willing to throw fucking money at. I mean, like, honestly, it's like, why are you guys not throwing more money at the it wasn't a cum shot. It was not. It was not the fucking money shot.
No, it wasn't. It was your tongue.
Like, what?
Tongue shot, not a cum shot, Dirk. There's a very big difference there.
I'm like, I'm willing to be there at the moment, but, like, still back away. Like, I'm still trying to, like, ease into this.
Wait, what are you backing away from? The tongue shot or the cum shot?
Well, the fucking cum shot is like totally something on you people.
We should. I sorry, I derailed like, it. We should not go there.
I'm ready, yo, bro.
we should. Okay, we'll go with Shooter McLoads. Money shot.
My whole like, you know, when I think about things, but like, not in a Twitch sense, right? Like, none of you understand what I think in a Twitch sense.
So have we gotten through Saturday yet? The schedule on Saturday?
It's Friday.
Are we still
fucking
working
on Saturday now?
It's
like,
Friday today, sorry.
We're Saturday. No, we're on Saturday. All right.
Wait.
So the one thing I talked about with the devs this week about the Saturday party during eVegas, don't feel bad when we get kicked out of cabanas or tables because that shit's already reserved for people who are coming to the club when it opens to the public. That shit happens in Vegas, you know, for parties like that. We'll get kicked off, but you know what? We get to fucking stay at Dre's afterwards. And if you know who Big Sean is, he's coming
Big
on after.
Sean's
us.
Gonna
Big
be there.
Sean.
Oh man.
I actually don't know who that is.
I took the
and
L
that
last
is what
night
is
and
so
I fucking
sad
bounced
about
back.
All of you who think that fucking Black Lives Matter, because this is where it all fucking happens.
I'm gonna have to like Google Big Sean after this.
See?
Do it.
You look out there and you go.
Did he? No, Big Sean did a couple good songs. You know who he is,
like,
Drake.
I've probably heard songs by him. I don't know. If I heard the song,
I'd
be like,
oh,
that guy. Hold on. You know what? I'm going to Spotify. Going to it.
He's on that Pharrell Williams and Katy Perry song, last Pills, whatever that song is.
Well, right? I don't listen to pop.
Thrills. Way, if you're on Thrills. Katy Perry, don't be afraid to catch like, feels.
I don't listen to pop music. I listen to like heavy metal and screamy shit. So like if it's
oh
not
my god, Drayden. Bounce Ray, back, sacrifice.
I don't you ever you judge literally him right now or out there listening
fuck
to the fucking Overcome show and don't know what a fucking 187
country music,
is.
That's what Rain listens to.
It's like,
all right, so hold on.
You should all
bounce
literally
back.
Go fucking kill yourself. In
I don't
game.
Know what song this is.
Bounce Back, is that his big thing?
Yeah, I was listening to it. It doesn't sound right.
Yeah. Last night I took an L, tonight I bounce back.
Last night
chocolate
I took an L.
Drop of rhyme and freestyle.
Yeah, that's a good
L. Okay. But tonight, you fucking bounce back.
Wait, this is the
premiere
show?
How can you fucking know that, Rain? It's like, look, this shit does not happen in fucking Des Moines.
What about
we
moves?
Recognize that? People
dirt?
Actually live out there.
Just because
in the
I'm in
world?
From Iowa doesn't mean I don't fucking explore the world. I'm like, you're a lazy ass who doesn't even have a fucking passport, okay?
Oh, shots
fucking roll my fucking Southside passport. I don't know. I played a couple of songs like right, in 10-second intervals, and
are you done firing shots?
Oh, I'm
are
not done
you?
Firing shots.
I really
don't
wait,
know.
Wait,
Nanoc,
wait,
I
can
I
we
quit
do
it.
Karaoke? DC, can we do karaoke? Like, I'm really
you
want to
do karaoke?
Miley Cyrus Party in the USA. Like, can
you guys
want to give it to me?
Sing?
Wait, I
want to
sing.
Right
I
now?
Really want to sing. I really
okay.
want to sing.
Okay, this is drunk Canadian. Drunk Canadian knows how to
drink.
Okay. Rain,
yeah,
right.
Yeah,
right. Rain, everybody shut the fuck up for a second. Hey! Hey, let DC talk.
Rain, I got a song for you. Are you ready?
Alright.
Look at me! I am Stevie Seats! Yes, sir!
Why would you do that?
Oh, okay, no.
What? You don't like Rick and Morty?
DC.
But I'm not gonna rat or sing Rick and Morty.
This.
I'll
Mr.
play your song. I'll play your song. I'll play your song.
All right.
Wait. Does it? No. Can you do Nicki Minaj Super Bass? Super Bass.
Fuck
oh,
you. It's your song. Wait.
Super
why'd
bass,
you stop?
Super bass. I can
it
rap
takes
that
me a
shit.
Second to get it, alright? Hang on.
Oh,
but like,
please.
I can breathe.
All right, I'm doing.
Second. Just fucking rub the tip of your fucking cock and you know you have a song you want to play.
That's all
okay,
I have
wait,
to do.
Okay, wait. Play rap song. We're all going to rap.
Why do I like, pay for Spotify? That's all I
moderator
do.
Moderator taught me how to rap, so
oh
we're all going to rap.
Fucking god, make a decision.
Moderator,
like a, do a rap.
What do you want to eat?
No! Miley,
shut up. Never play that crap again and take a shot.
Wait,
never play that crap again and take a shot by Looney.
What are you talking about?
Did you see it?
Are we going to play
yeah,
Looney?
Yeah, I just
Looney
screamed it at you.
Call Ludacris.
Well, just play the Miley Cyrus shit.
No, Drayden, did you see the tip?
We got $100.
Oh no, I didn't. Wait, this is
not
like
I'm totally
again.
Fucking down for. We are totally
shit,
doing that fucking night.
Wait,
goddamn
wait.
Fucking karaoke. Because I'm gonna tell you
Dirk,
right now.
Dirk,
I
will out-rap you.
Like,
I will out-rap you, you fucking.
Wait.
Fuck you, you wish. I will fucking jam
I'm gonna
my
fucking. We're gonna.
Ludicrous.
Shut up.
So, yeah,
wait! Okay. So, Looney Fucker, I was calling it.
I literally killed myself in real
Looney
life.
Fucker donated $100. Was there a message with that?
He said to do a shot. He said to do a shot.
It.
Well, then let's do it.
You're gonna do a
I
shot?
Read it, you fuckers. I read it. You have to listen
fuck
to the girl.
It. I'm on this nip. This nip I own.
Fuck, drink, well, chug, chug,
that's
chug,
his
chug, chug. Okay, Dirk, okay, stop chugging now. You can, Jerk.
Okay, now
oh,
stop.
Oh, God. Oh, Dirk, stop. No.
No, he's
oh
gone. He's
God,
gone tonight.
Team.
It's over.
He's gone. Okay.
It's over.
He's dead. Dirk is dead tonight, actually. Like,
fuck that bitch. I heard her squirt.
Nope. What?
Yeah.
Give me shots now.
Can we all not jam now, motherfucker?
Yeah.
You still on the real show? Oh my
God!
Sing it,
Ray. 1049.
From your head
to your toes, I wanna.
Okay.
This
makes so good you wanna leave to make it.
That was my middle school. I'm so sorry.
There's a problem here. I'm drunk as fuck, and the offset is triggering me. So I can only
but
I can only
the off-
imagine what
you can't you can't let the offset screw you because there's always
fuck
gonna be offset
that
if
means,
you play it from
that means
you
drunk shut the fuck up, Drayden.
No!
Shut the fuck up.
Okay, yes.
This means we can only end on what fucking drunk Canadian recognizes as being true. West motherfucking laid down fucking rap.
Black Street. So
whatever song you put Black right Street. Now, it better be a 187 motherfucker.
Black Street.
I got one for you, Derek. I got one for you, Derek. You guys do
what's
your thing.
What's your name?
I got
one. All right. Just play a song. I'm gonna sing it. We're gonna sing
number
it.
One.
Drunk Canadian. Play
Vietnam
Black Street. Play Black Street.
Or you're fucking willing to pull down. This is how we fucking gangbang out in the fucking Compton, motherfucker.
You play some Nicki Minaj. I'm really good at rapping.
No, not Nicki Minaj.
I'm really good at rapping, Drayden.
Black Street.
Backstreet, not
dude,
Black
Street. No, it's Black Street. Like,
all right, I'm going to freestyle rap.
Don't Google it, Ray. It's Black Street.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Let your body.
See why? Oh hey!
Oh my God, we're back again.
Brothers, sisters, everybody, gotta bring the flavor.
Turn down. Why did you down?
Got a question for you. Better answer now. Yeah.
It's down. Better song than that, man.
I swear to God.
Derek wanted something West Coast.
It's so fucking sad.
That's not West Coast. That's like
Oblivion
Coast.
Oh my God, shut up.
Roll up with a fucking iced tea, or can you get some goddamn actual West Coast shit? Like, I know you know what West Coast means.
Dr. Dre!
What the rest of his niggas do? Man, the motherfuckers is ready for anything.
I can't say the N-word because...
Are you ready to fight 187, nigga, right now? I mean, like, can you do it?
Whoa, Dirk!
Whoa.
This one's the boys of the boom.
Come on, motherfuckers, come on!
Release the brainstorm to make the motherfucking brainstorm.
What the hell is this shit? It's carnival music.
Wait, was that the theme song for?
It's Biggie Smalls and Thomas the Train Engine.
No,
yes.
Fucking, like, Biggie Smalls, honestly, like unless he actually meant to be like, can you shoot me, motherfucker? Can you shoot
How
me,
about you play some Black Street?
It doesn't matter.
Oh, here we go.
That's
here we go.
It. I don't know.
Are you ready?
This.
Are you ready?
I don't know what this is. I don't know it.
This one's for the boys. The boom is just top down AC with the coolest system. When they come in the club, he be blazing up. Got sex on deck like he's saving up. And he ill, he kills, he might get a deal. He popples and he got the right kind of pill. He old, he dumb, he might sell coke. He always in the air, but he never fly coach. He need a motherfucker trip, chip, some on a ship. When he make a dip, zip, kiss him on the lip. That's the kind of dude I was looking for. And yes, you get stabbed if you're looking home. Oh, excuse me, you're a humble guy. You gotta really... I mean, you're so shy. Oh, yes I did. Somebody tell him who the F I is, cause I'm Nicki Minaj. Back dudes up, back coos up, voice. Heartbeat running. So I can't, you gotta auto-tune me here. John Man is coming your way.
Actually, back when this bitch rolled down, nobody heard a bitch fucking.
So this is a really good dance part, but I can't dance. But it's really fun.
I got you!
And you shut your mouth.
Fuck this shit. This is how we should roll into the next show.
Hey, you got that super bass? This one is for the boys and the powwows. Alright, they swear a bunch here. Thank you.
I can't do it anymore. I can't listen to that crap.
I know, really. Huh. When you say crap, you don't actually mean, like, the generational crap that shit was throwing out, right?
Because, she does! Whoa!
Did not matter.
There is good music that comes out of this generation, but that right there is a giant.
I swear to God.
No, there's nothing good that comes out of here.
She's a terrible role model for all human beings.
Nicki Minaj can rap, though, okay? I don't give a fuck what you think about her. She can rap! Fuck you!
Like, that is not
rap. This was for the boys that boom. With the coolest system. When he comes in the clubs, he'd be blazing up. Got stacks on deck like he's saving up. Like, I'm a fucking white girl. I can rap that shit.
Can you?
Oh my god. The fact that you are not a rapper and you can do the rapping.
I'm gonna be honest. I totally fucking gave fucking Rain that shit.
And you know I'm right. That's why you're looking away and fucking smiling. You know it's true.
Fuck off. She's really good to listen to.
Rain fucking rocked that shit for like.
And she is not a professional rapper. Moment. To say that that girl has good rapping skills, and any Joe Blow or Joe Ray can fucking mimic it.
You're gonna question
she's
her
better,
goddamn
she's
rapping
better than
skills?
Iggy Azalea. For women rapping, that's good.
Okay, a potato is better than Iggy Azalea. That's not saying much.
Hold on. Her hips, yes. But, like, honestly, I mean, it's like...
Popcorn metal.
What?
Nobody pray for me.
What?
Yeah.
I remember serving. That's not me. I was like, that's not me. I was like, wait, this went weird.
Like being like, fuck you, bitches.
You have zero chill, Derek.
Give me just one fucking iced tea 6 a.m.
I'm not giving you iced tea.
Not iced tea.
I can't do it.
Can we do,
give me six in the morning.
What's that one song? Vanilla Ice, Ice Baby? Can we do that song? That's like rap, right? That's like white person rap?
But that guy stood on stage in front of me at one point and I sat there with, honestly, bro, 6 a.m.
No, please don't play this.
No, we can't. No, we gotta sing it.
Is the parody?
Yes, Indo Pelion, we can do this.
We can.
I can't actually do it.
I don't know the words actually at all.
I will cry for
something. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Oh, did I fuck it up? Well, they pop like this. The 4th or 5th when the FC falls,
cause the Lodgy drift, the shattered fleet retreat. Hallelujah!
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 Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Why are we doing this?
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
So, like, this is gonna be off of, like, your stream. Like, it sounds
it's
right.
So
to me, but
awful.
It's so
awful. I guarantee it. The ship was strong, but you really goofed things. Are you riding in your boat? I'm taking shots.
I like how we just ignored chat and like they're like, guys, you need to fucking stop singing. We're
they
like,
should. They go shots from the bottle for chat because they have to put up with this shit.
Doing shots?
No, it's a good song, but listening to us sing it is awful.
Fuck that shit. I will literally chop all of your motherfucking hands off. Because
my hands, sir? My hands?
This girl's voice
my hands?
Screwed to all of us in fucking Eve.
Yeah.
All of you need to fucking die with your fucking hands and my fucking hands.
Are you threatening me?
So I'm gonna go play
fuck
PUBG.
Fuck yes, I'm threatening you. Because you know what? Your fucking hands deserve to be in my hands. About why you cut that fucking song off. Number one, that girl right there sang that fucking song better than anybody in fucking Eve.
I'm still hung up on you threatening me.
Because you and your fucking, we gave you your goddamn fucking mechanized infantry fucking rig. Okay, it's like, look, that's how it fucking rolls. Don't make me send Jay McClane up there after you.
Oh, a retired guy that...
Whatever, I'm just saying.
Hey, man, you couldn't hack
anyways,
it. It's fine.
Can't we all just fucking roll back onto
Mr. Meeseeks?
Why can't we have some ghetto rap? Why can't we have a motherfucker that will sit there and be like, you know what?
Why do you want ghetto rap?
Dirk, for the one time and the last time in your fucking life.
You're the whitest person I know.
Why is that a problem?
I know, because I grew up when colors fucking mattered.
Colors mattered?
Fuck yeah, man. Fucking red and blue fucking mattered back in my day.
Matted, or...
Oh my God. I'm telling you right now, can you play Colors? Colors. Fuck yeah, Colors. Colors. Good, seriously,
oh
right now,
God.
Play that
He's
song
not
and
being
say
racist
it's not
yet.
Fucking
He's not
me saying
racist yet. He's literally talking about Colors. He's not
it's
being
a song?
I'm talking about fucking
Drain.
Colors.
No, Drain,
I'm
the time,
about
the time.
Time.
Oh, oh,
time.
Oh, hey, hold on, everyone, stop!
Fuck this shit, if you play Colors
no,
right
stop!
Now,
like,
I will rap
DC,
that.
Stop, DC, stop! Stop!
We're
stop!
Gonna,
hey!
No, we're not. No, we're not. If he can play,
I'm Drake, muting. Right I'm now, muting everyone.
Motherfucker, we're at time, motherfucker.
I muted everyone. Sorry, we're out of time. Julie's up next. She's playing probably some Jackbox, maybe some. Oh shit! What's the game called? Warframe. Okay, one of the two. Stay tuned for her. We're out of here. Peace, bitches. Sorry, everyone's loud as fuck. I had to mute them. Bye.